Good morning, everybody. Good morning, America. Okay? You're watching Jim Weller with Weller Does Delmarva. It is a weekly show. We do it right here live on My Cozi TV, and you're invited to continue to watch the show. There's no charge to watch it. It's going to be very interesting. We have no idea what we're going to talk about because we get up on Saturday mornings, and we start thinking about this show about 5 minutes after it starts, sometimes 5 minutes before. But it's going to be a lot of fun. Got some guests going to be on, and I'm going to jump right to the young man sitting to my left, probably your right. His name is Colin Walls. That's what he goes by.
That's what I go by. Good morning.
He goes by. Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, I even answer to that.
Do you really?
Yeah, I do.
Well, I haven't talked to you in a while since yesterday. So anyway, Christmas tree sales are brisk.
Yeah, Christmas tree sales are going really well.
People seem to be, I think there's quite a lot of excitement going on in the country in general right now.
Right.
And I think people this year here are not in the artificial mood. I think they want a real tree.
Well, I guess.
Or a fresh cut or whatever you call it.
Yeah, something. They're into real this year, I think they are. Yeah.
I think there's more hope.
Right. You think so?
I do. I really do. And, I mean, you can always put your artificial tree up, but you can't always get a real one.
So you're saying there's no hope in an artificial tree?
I'm saying that anything artificial, whether it be a political leader or a tree, doesn't excite people.
Our Christmas trees have entered into the political realm now.
Yes, they have. They're real. And they're going to make America great one tree at a time. How about that?
Yeah.
They're at least going to make your house happy.
Okay.
Okay?
That sounds
good. They're nice. And anyway, he's back with them cards already.
Oh,
boy. Must have forgot about them.
Oh, boy. We better get on topic.
So let's
he
get
needs
going.
One that says get on topic.
That was saying the clock is rolling.
The clock All is
right.
rolling. Okay.
So Yuletide Farms.
Yes.
Nothing to do with Yule Brenner, correct?
No, but it has to do with Yule Logs.
Yule Logs.
And you'll love it there.
And you'll love it there.
Right.
And you'll love movie night, Outdoor Under the Stars.
That's right. Yeah.
Is it a night that's going to be starry?
I'm not sure.
Okay, well, there'll at least be darkness and maybe a moon.
Yep, we're counting on darkness that night. I did see that in the forecast.
Okay.
That there will be darkness, so we're going to start with that.
Because it's an outside movie amphitheater.
That's right.
That you've built with straw.
Yeah. I don't know that I would go to the amphitheater description
Well, let's
yet,
put it like this. It's probably, you could safely say there's no other outdoor movie theater like it in Delaware.
On that piece of property, for sure.
Okay. On that day at that time.
That's right.
All right. Okay.
Okay.
All right, now.
We burned up a minute on this stuff.
Okay. Yuletide Farm. Let's stay on the Christmas trees for starters. Okay.
Oh,
anything
I'm going
else?
With that?
All right. Okay. I like the machine you have to shake them.
To shake them. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
You claim that they wake the trees up.
Right. They get them breathing.
Video.
You drill that hole in the bottom and
right.
They
give
can
them some
suck
air.
Water up better and they start breathing. Up to that place, they were just sleeping there. They're getting ready to go on a road trip.
Well, you know what? You know what happened
what?
Last week? The Department of Agriculture inspector came out.
Okay.
And he's checking them because they check for bugs and diseases.
Really?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
So they
That's
check for all
idea.
That. And he called me up and complimented me. He said, "I've been to however many places he's been to see."
Okay.
He said, "I've never seen anybody put them in water."
Most people just get them, stick them out there, and that's it.
Right.
Well, yeah. I like how you drill the hole even.
Right.
So it can get the water up in there.
Right.
All right. I would like to talk to you more about this, but my time is up. Anyway, Yuletide Farm is a Christmas tree farm.
It is.
Now, if somebody had a business and they want a big one, like a big, I don't know, do they make 10-footers, 15-footers?
Yes, they are made.
With a big ball on the bottom.
We don't have them with the balls.
Oh, really?
No, no.
All right.
No.
Okay, so you would cut it down.
Yep, we cut them down.
Big ones now.
Big ones. I've actually got one on the trailer right now that somebody's coming to pick up.
You
somebody's
kept
already
right
ordered.
There on the
no,
trailer.
We don't cut them down until they're ordered. And it's probably a 14-footer, and it's probably,
are you delivering it?
No, it's probably 8-foot diameter.
Wow.
Across, yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Show me that again.
Yep.
Eight foot.
There's six.
Okay.
And then
so add two more foot.
Add two more of these.
Do you add it? On 1 foot on each side?
And one on each end, yeah.
Okay, not two foot on one side.
If I was over that way a foot, then you would add it both on that
no,
side.
No, what I meant is hold your arms out again.
Yeah.
I meant do they add 2 feet total to that side
no.
or this side?
1 foot to that side, 1 foot to that
okay.
side.
Okay. You got that?
Yeah.
All right. This is a litmus test. Okay, let's be serious. This is a very serious business.
Test.
A witness test.
Yeah.
Folks, I do need to tell you, this is not rehearsed. Okay? We have
even
not
though it sounds like it.
This is real, okay? This is as real as the Christmas trees are. Okay.
All right, so Yuletide Farm, we're just outside of Milford. Yes, YuletideFarm.com. Just outside of Milford, just off of Route 36, Yuletide Lane, like you're heading towards Slaughter Beach. If you're coming on Route 1, you want to get on the Route 36 East exit. Head east, and then we're like the third place on your left-hand side. Also, we're going to have a movie night. We talked about the theater. We'll talk about that in the next segment. Okay. YuletideFarm.com, Yuletide Farm on Facebook.
Okay.
Facebook. Thank you.
I'm going to leave you, and thank you. Okay. How about that?
Thank you.
All right. Are we on the radio yet?
Not quite.
All right. So, folks, we're going to go on the radio. So if you have to get up and quit watching on TV or the stream, you can tune your radio into Delaware 105.9. We're going to be there in just a few minutes. And we do that especially for the travelers, okay? So if you get up and got to get rolling, you won't miss a minute of the show. Another thing I do want to tell you is that we are now live on the radio. So good morning to my Delaware 105.9 audience. So you are listening to Jim Weller. Weller Does Delmarva. This is a live weekly radio show. We're on My Cozi TV. We are on Facebook Live, and we are also streaming at WellerDoesDelmarva.com. So if you feel you've missed anything or you just enjoyed the show so much, you must want to watch it again. We do not charge anything extra for people to view it the second time. Okay? Now, if you do happen to accidentally watch it three times, there's going to be an automatic charge on your credit card. So you can call Brooks now to give him your credit card info. So that way, in the event you watch this show three times, there's only a charge. How much do we charge?
Let's go with five.
Five. Five what?
I was going to hope that you were going to roll with that.
$5.
I was hoping you were going to roll with that. That way
we don't
you
charge anything, folks. This is free. It's worth every daggone penny you're paying for this show, all
Absolutely.
Right? Absolutely. Right. So who we got on today?
We have Brandon's going to be on.
Brandon's going to be
on. Yep, and then we're going to always have the infamous Barry from Dry Zone.
Okay.
And then Dr. T from Peninsula Chiropractic is going to be on a little
bit. Is he really?
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
Going to be exciting.
So we got a lot of people.
We do.
We're going to get the kinks out, and he's going to keep you straight.
I think Brandon's got a lot to talk about.
Do you really?
I think so.
All right, well, anyway.
We'll find out.
When's he coming on?
Right after you do your first spot.
For real?
Yeah.
All right, well, let's do the first spot. Our good friend Jerry Santoro, Jerry's Lawn Care. Real good guy. You hear me talk about him week after week after week, and I talk to people that deal with him week after week. First of all, he did all of our lawn care here at Weller's through the summer and did a great job. But now he's really into firewood. So if you happen to need any firewood, he has got the firewood, okay? And he'll deliver it, or you can pick it up, whatever you want to do. Also, he does lot clearing, all right? So now you're wondering where he gets the firewood. He does lot clearing. If you have a lot you want cleared, you got a tree you want cut down, trimmed up, you got a stump you want ground up or dug up, he can do it all. Lot clearing. He also does pavers. E.P. Henry Pavers. They're the good ones, okay? He is certified. He is trained. He knows what he's doing. And anything that he has to offer, if you want an estimate, estimates are absolutely free. So you just give him a call. Now, it is also the time of year, if you've got a irrigation system in your yard, you best have it winterized, hopefully by now. But if you don't have it winterized, you call Jerry and he'll take care of that too. So any lawn care needs, firewood, clearing a lot, pavers, or winterizing or installing a new irrigation system, he can help you with that. All right, so what in the world's his phone number? It is 363-6025. 363-6025. It's called Jerry's Lawn Care, and on the web, it's jlc-llc.com. jlc-llc.com. Okay, so there we go. So what are we doing next? Next is I'm going to talk about some of these products we have for sale. One of them right here is this little button. It says, and this is a rare thing, and not many places even sell this button. So I presume you can see it, but I think it says something like, it's okay to wish me Merry Christmas. So I think that means a lot of places are not allowed by law or by, you know, company rule to wish you Merry Christmas, okay? Which is really odd because technically every calendar has the word Christmas on it. So for a business to forbid an employee, you know, and threaten them with lawsuits and losing their job for saying it. But I recently was on a radio show. I was doing the Dan Gaffney show. And I asked people, how's that work? And some people said where they work, if you say it first as a customer, they're allowed to say it back. But if you don't say it first, they can't say it. So it's an amazing thing that we live in the United States of America, and every calendar that's hanging on everybody's wall has the word Christmas on it. But some stores would fire, or I don't know what they would do to an employee. I don't know what to what degree they would do to them, but, you know, for saying Merry Christmas. So I'm letting you know, at Weller's, we have a little button, and it says it's okay to wish me a Merry Christmas. Okay? And these things here, I think, are $5 each. No, I had the number wrong. They're $2 each. It's three for $5. I thought they were $5 each. So anyway, we've got them. I don't think we have an abundance of them, but if you want one, what a great little stocking stuffer or gift to give to somebody, or wear it yourself, and we've got them. So the next thing, let me switch to Brandon. He's here right now, and I'll slow up. What have you got to talk about?
Well, I was going to go right along with what you're doing here is mention a lot of things. We've got a lot of
All right, what are you showing?
Items. Well, show this, these tags. Since you
All right,
right
go ahead. These tags have quite a story to them.
We have metal license plates here.
Would we call them novelty tags?
Yes, novelty tags. The ones we're
showing
here.
So they don't
here.
Replace your rear tag?
No, no. Okay. They go on the front of your vehicle.
Okay.
One of them says, if you can't run with the big dogs, stay on the porch.
Okay.
We get a lot of laughs. A lot of the customers come
Brooks
in.
Brooks tells you that all the time.
Yeah. Yeah, he thinks he's a big dog. But
okay.
It's a little dog.
What can I say? You know?
Right.
And so a lot of people like that. They buy that to put on the front of their vehicle. The other one here, and you hear it a lot, and I think actually Matt Monks did a trivia thing on his show about this other tag here. It says race car spelled backwards is race car. And I think his trivia question was, what vehicle is spelled the same backwards? And if you think about it, a race car is a vehicle.
Oh, well, I'm thinking Ford, Chevy, Dodge.
So we've got these here. They're a great deal. They're going to be $2 each as well.
$2 each. Man, I can remember when we sold them for $20.
Yeah.
Yep. And, well, I can tell you this. We sell some of this stuff on eBay for $19.95.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess we do sell them for almost $20. They're $2 each.
Yep, or you can
get
three for
five.
Them
three for five, too?
We are.
I do want to tell a quick story. You can only get these tags anywhere in the world. They're only available at Weller's in Bridgeville. And the reason is because I've had them for probably 20 years or better. Been in business 42 years. But I had this idea, and I had these made. And I remember they cost me a tremendous amount of money because I paid the company to design them, make the mold. It's really called a stamp. They're stamped out of aluminum. So these are nice aluminum license plates. $2 each, though. You can't go wrong. So his and her special, or three for five if there's a his and a her, and just a good friend. So anyway, three for $5. And we have, what, probably 20, 30 different styles of other tags,
yes.
too?
Yep.
And they're all in that group, right?
Yes, yep.
They're all in the group of $2 each, three
right.
for five.
Yep.
All right, what's the next thing you want to show everybody?
Another thing that's real popular, I don't know. Got
he's
one in
getting
here.
The most popular thing out, but he's not sure.
I was going to hit socks.
Socks. Okay, they're here somewhere. Why don't I talk about this in the meantime?
Yeah.
This is a little thing that looks like a little teeny loaf of bread. It's called our daily bread. It's kind of neat. It's just a little promise box, and it has 240 scriptures in it. So like 120 cards printed on both sides, and each day you just pull one out and read it. Just a nice little gift if you got somebody you want to give a gift to, whether it be a friend or a co-worker or your boss or a school teacher or a Sunday school teacher or anything like that. In fact, I don't even know exactly how much they are because we got too many ads floating. So I want to let you know that they are $4 each, and you can get three of them for $10. All right. And what we're doing is we're reviewing our best ads we've ran all year. It's the end of the year, and we are dumping, liquidating inventory, okay? And you can tell by the prices, we really are. If you were to go into like a place and buy one of these, they're like $7 or $8 for one. So, and we've got them for $4 a piece.
Yeah,
so
they are a great deal. I had a lady call yesterday. She wants to come in and buy 15 of them.
15 of them. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're just a great little gift. You know,
they are.
Especially if you want to, you know, give something to somebody that may encourage them or inspire them or speak to their heart. So stocking stuffer, you're right. And we have the stockings that you can stuff. All right, so now we're going to go to socks,
we're
folks.
Going to socks. Now, these have been extremely popular this year.
Yeah.
I mean, and I think it has to do with the incredible price you have
I would
on
say
right
it does
now.
Because we've got people buying hundreds at a time. In other words, a lot of them give them away to shelters and people in need and stuff like that. But How much are they?
That right now we've got the socks. You get 30 pairs of socks.
That's 60 socks.
60 socks.
Real quick, Brooks, how many toes?
Oh, I'm not thinking.
Okay.
No problem. That's 600, right?
Yeah, folks. 600 toes.
Break out the calculator.
Yeah. 60 pairs, 30 pairs of socks is 60 socks. 60 times 5
is 300.
If Brooks is counting your money, is 600. If I'm counting the money, it's 300.
It's 300.
Okay. 300 toes. And I guess some people, I've been scolded on this, it's not really 300 toes. Because aren't different toes called different things?
Oh, yeah. I know when it,
no?
when it comes to your hands, like you only have, you have eight fingers and two thumbs.
Well, that was the logic they were trying to feed.
But I think on your feet, I think it's five toes.
Right.
But, I mean, some people do have more than five toes
like
sometimes.
Like Maloney to me when they were saying it. But anyway, 30 pair of socks for $10, and you can buy 100 pair, 200 pair, 500 pair.
Right.
We are going to run out of them.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, we at one time had like 80,000 pairs of socks, and I think right now we're less than 1,000 pairs, or is it 1,000 packs of six?
Well, it goes into packs of six, and we're actually, we're definitely less than 1,000.
1,000 packs of six. So we're under 10,000 socks at this point.
Yes.
Okay, and if a plane gets below 10,000 in altitude, it's got problems.
Yeah, it's a big problem.
So anyway, we are just about out of socks, so 30 pair for $10, and that's good till when? The end of the year, I see.
That's correct.
All right. And all these ads are viewable at Wellers.com because there's way more than we can mention.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What's next?
Next is another very popular item. We sell these
180th scale
every single day. They're flying off the shelf. It's a 180th scale.
And they're not planes.
And they're not. They're actually little trucks. So
little tractor trailers.
They're driving off the shelves.
Right. So these are a collectible item that some people buy, or you could let kids play with them.
Yeah, I have a good friend of mine that is big into the die-cast models of everything. Like,
is this a die-cast thing?
I don't.
Or is it like a die-cast?
It's a limited edition die-cast collectible.
Oh, it's fully licensed?
Mm-hmm. Yep, completely.
It's a Peterbilt truck? Okay.
This one in particular is a Major League.
That part's not licensed. It says it right there, though. All right. Well, anyway.
This one in particular is the Brewers, but we also have a few other selections. We have the Ravens. I think the Texas Rangers. A few other different teams there.
The Braves.
The Braves. Braves, yeah. So, okay. But
the Dallas Braves.
The Atlanta Braves.
Atlanta. The Atlanta Braves. Okay.
But anyways, we.
The Mojave Braves.
We've got these in the store. People love them. Like I said, I was saying, a friend of mine, he collects a lot of these die casts. He's big into tractor trailers and trucks and stuff like that.
Well, if he is, he probably knows these could be bought and resold at the price we're selling.
Absolutely. And
seven
we encourage that. Or two for ten. Makes them $5 each.
Yeah. All right, $7 each, 2 for $10. Okay, so that's another crazy item we're selling.
Yeah. So.
All right, what is this thing here? This gold looking. I don't know if it's solid gold.
I think it's a cereal
it's empty,
bowl.
So it can't be solid gold. Okay? Is this a dog bowl or a planter?
I think it's a planter, but you could use it for a dog bowl.
You could use it for a dog bowl.
Or a stand.
Or a stand or a plant stand. Or you could put candy on it on the counter. Or a top hat, right.
Or drums.
So, cymbals, drums. And man, it's just endless here. Huh?
It is.
All right. So, anyway, whatever you want to do with it or call it, it's called a brass-colored planter. It's about 6.5 inches in diameter and 5 inches tall, $2 each. Pretty cheap.
Oh, yeah.
$2 each.
And so, if you want a pallet of them, we probably have it.
Really? Okay. So, what we're saying is, if you are viewing or listening and you say, I could buy this stuff and resell it on eBay, or, you know, go do a yard sale. It's okay with us. It's okay with us.
And I think the moral of the story is it's Christmas time, and when you're thinking Christmas shopping, Weller's is not just trailers.
That's a very good point.
We've got a lot of selection here with different things. I mean, you can just see the background if you're watching on my Cozi
TV. What's really interesting is it's all a bargain.
It is.
Everything that's abnormal that we sell way below market value.
Right.
And it's because somebody called me on the phone and said, do you want to buy a truckload of widgets? And I'm like, what's in there? Oh, I don't know. But you just buy it with your eyes closed.
Right.
And you've witnessed it. That's how we buy.
Right.
Not all the time. Like when we buy a trailer, we know exactly what we're getting.
Exactly.
But all this weird stuff that we sell, we just buy it by the tractor trailer load. We don't know what we're getting until we open the doors. And it's kind of fun and interesting. I got this thing here. Grab a couple other things, Brandon.
Okay.
But this is a thing that slides in a hitch cover. And it's oval, and it's big enough that you could literally letter it with some type of a message. And we used to sell these for $20, $25. I think we're down to our last 10 or 20 of them. And I'm selling them for $7.50 each. So you could get one, take it, and have it lettered World's Greatest Pup-Up or something like that, or, you know, World's Greatest Mom, and give it to your mom or your grandfather or whoever you want to. Or if you own a business, you could put it on there. If you got a message you want to put, you could put that on there. So we have those. Are those the holy poles?
These are world famous.
The only place in the world you can buy these is right here, because I bought every one the man had, and the mold is broke. So these are for hanging fishing rods. So you would bolt this. You would bolt this to like in your basement, up in the rafters, or your garage, or whatever. And the fishing rods just hang right in there. So here's what two of them would look like that, if you can see them.
And of course, we're known here at Weller's making different uses for the same item. You can hang fishing poles there, but you can also hang your water hose.
And if you put them real close together, you could put rolls of coins.
Okay, you could.
Or one coin. But anyway, these things here are normally $20, and you get a pair of them.
Yep.
Right now, we have cut the price just a little bit. 10% off would be, what, $18?
That's correct.
And then 20% off would be?
$16.
All right, so what would 30% off of 20 be?
$14.
All right, so what would 40% off be?
$12.
50%?
$10.
All right, so 60%?
Would be $8.
Dad, go on, Brooks, you're hanging right there with me. All right, 70% off?
$6.
All right, 80% off?
$4.
We're at more than 80% off, folks. I feel like one of the big box stores selling clothing. So anyway, they're $3.75 for a holdy pole. And I'll tell you what else you can use them for, and you mentioned other things, mm-hmm. but they're really neat for hanging extension cords.
Yeah.
In other words, or garden hose or something like that. You know. So for $3.75, you get two of them. And if you're not hanging fishing rods, you can use them in two separate places, you know.
And if you're a kayaker, they're really good for holding your paddles.
Ooh, that's another good one.
That's a good idea.
Man, you guys, I've got to commend you. You're on it today. Chin up, Mars. I want to video that one.
Yes. Okay. Yes, okay. That would be an America's Money's Funniest Video.
We are not trained professionals, and all these suggestions are simply a suggestion. Okay, use our suggestions at your own risk. Okay, all right. What do you got here? A roadside emergency kit? Does it have a pair of gloves?
It has a pair of gloves.
Okay, I had somebody ask me that.
Yep, it's insulated jumper cables in it. Screwdrivers.
Oh, I love that versus uninsulated. Okay.
Well, when it's cold outside, you might want them.
Okay, I was thinking more. You didn't want to get shocked.
Well,
but
that's
either
too,
one.
But insulated is insulated.
But I want my jumper cables warm when it's time to use them.
It's got some sockets, electrical tape.
Really?
Pliers, nut driver set, a carrying
case.
What
volt electrical tape? 110 or 12 volt?
I'm going to let you answer that one, Jim.
Oh, you're kidding me.
I'm not going to fall into that trap.
What is that, $14 and something?
The standard selling price on it is $14.97, and you have it on sale for Christmas.
$7.77? That's almost 50% off.
Yeah.
I must have not known they were $15 to start with.
Uh-oh.
All right. Seven. Do I have many?
We got a few out there.
Okay. We'll keep it at a few. Don't reorder them until the sale's over.
Okay.
$7.77. So that's a nice little gift. Got some screwdriver and pliers. Do I see an air gauge in there?
Yes.
It's got air gauge. So just some few things. Okay. Brooks has got a sign that he holds up. This is really, we need to let the audience see this sometime.
Flashing
how
time
hard
is up.
He works. Okay. So he is letting us know that we have become long-winded, okay? And all we could say is we have been in training with Brooks, all right? But other than that, we're doing pretty good. Are we done?
I guess we're done.
Are you going to have people call you on your cell phone this early, or you just want them to call the store?
Oh, they can call me on my cell phone. I'm always ready.
You've gotten a little more generous with that.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, he's increased his debt load for folks.
I have.
And he's more willing to talk to people.
I have all to right, sell some trailers. It's 302-542-7794. It's on
call
right
now.
Call
him now, just to make sure he's awake. 542-7794.
Yep.
All right, thank you, Brandon. And he'll be in sales. Brooks will be in sales. Store opens at 8. Brooks probably won't be in there till 9, but either way, they're ready to sell you something. So can we talk about Mid-South Audio real quick?
I think it's a great idea.
It's a great idea because they're next on the schedule. This is Kevin Short, our friend that owns Mid-South Audio, and they have all kinds of things. If you're putting on an event, a concert, in fact, you've got a little story to tell. You know somebody that's having a Christmas party?
Yes.
Did they have it already?
No, it's tonight.
Okay, now what is Mid-South Audio doing? In fact, I'm just going to say it's Dry Zone,
yep.
One of our good friends and sponsors. They're having their Christmas party tonight.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And since you're part of the show, they've invited you to come. Is that right?
Well, I was actually going to be helping them out.
Oh, okay. Until Mid-South Audio came along.
Yes, the equipment that was needed.
All right. So tell us quickly what kind of equipment.
They didn't have what they thought they needed.
Well,
so Mid-South Audio is going to be there. They're going to have a stage. They're going to have
a
projector. They're going to have a screen.
They have screens? Yep. I never even thought of that. They have a projector screen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep. So they're going to actually be... they're giving some awards and stuff tonight.
Really?
So that way they can have some videos and stuff that they were going to play. So Mid-South Audio is going to hook them up and help them out with all the equipment that they need.
I hope the awards were not a surprise. Anyway, we'll be there to receive them. But anyway, Mid-South Audio does this. So for example, and I actually think it was spur of the moment that they realized they needed this much stuff.
Yeah, it was.
You know, they called them up. Kevin Short and his team met him over there, and where is it at? Heritage Shores, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, I'm just saying, and, you know, they're just getting it all done for him.
Yeah.
Any microphones or amps or anything like that?
I would assume so. They're going to need to be able
lighting.
To talk.
So they do it all. So what we're saying is whether you're having a concert or a Christmas party or you're building a new room or facility that needs a complete sound system, they can help you. Okay?
Absolutely.
Mid-South Audio, 856-6993, 856-6993, MidSouthAudio.com. And real quick, I want to mention that Kevin Short is part of the group called The Reminders, and they're playing this Thursday night. It is this Thursday night. Yes, it is. At the Schwartz Center in Dover, and Friday night at Crossroad Community Church. And if you want to learn more about it, go to www.TheReminders.net for more details and where they're playing and when they're playing and if there's a cost or no cost and so on and so forth. That's The Reminders. They have been out for about a year and they are just ramping back up and people have missed them. All right, so we're going to be having Barry from Dry Zone on in a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
After we go at about 7:30, I'm going to talk to Colin Walls some more about Yuletide Farm and the movie night. I've thought of some questions in the meantime that I want to ask him. So anyway, got a lot going on, and you are watching and listening to Weller Does Delmarva. Brandon's cell phone number, what was it again?
542-7794.
And we do need people to call him right now.
Absolutely.
Absolutely, right now, right this minute, and say, I want two of that and seven of this and so on and so forth. I guess we'll box it up and ship it to him if we have to. Right?
Sure, I'm sure we could.
Yeah, because our new website's going to have a store on it.
Absolutely.
So we got to get ready for that, folks. We've heard rumors that businesses ship things, and we're going to start doing it, too. Is that right?
Yep. Heard it through the grapevine.
So we've been selling stuff on eBay and Amazon like crazy. And
yeah.
Just getting our new website critiqued and fine-tuned. And, you know, we're going to launch that thing. Is it January 1st, or what are you thinking?
That's the plan.
That's the plan.
We're working on it really hard, and it's coming along.
Okay. And it's looking good. So anyway, I want you to stay excited and stay tuned. Maybe we'll have a launch party.
That works for me.
Get Mid-South Audio in here and set up a stage and all that
Get
stuff.
Strobe lights and stage lights.
And dancers and cheerleaders and everything else. Maybe have some free food and then launch the website that you could see from home.
Yeah.
So we don't have to buy much food. All right. So anyway, Weller's is going to be open 8 o'clock today?
Yes.
All right. And we've been selling trailers. Didn't you have a special order just come in?
I did, yes.
What kind of stuff did that person get?
It actually, he got some E-track in the floor, which
okay.
basically makes it so you can put a D-ring wherever
Every
you need it.
Every inch or two if you want.
Exactly.
Okay.
It had a...
Is it recessed in the floor?
Yes, it's recessed
okay,
and trimmed out the floor.
Are we taking a break from
yes,
the radio
yes,
yet?
Yes, we are.
Okay, so we're going to take a break from the radio. If you're on the radio, go over to Facebook or MyCozy TV and watch us because we got something we're going to tell you about during the break. And then we'll be back with more Weller Does Delmarva. Tell me when we're back on TV or Facebook. We're back.
Did he say that the trailer had an 8-track player in it? Is that what he said?
It's special order. You know how hard it was to find an 8-track player? E-track.
Oh, an E-track player. Oh, what is an E-track player?
E-track is like a strip of metal.
Yeah.
It can come a foot long or 20 foot long that has these little slots in it. That you take a little bracket and you put it in there, and you can strap things down. So you might have something that's 2 foot wide and you want to strap it down, and then you might have something that's 18 foot wide and you want to strap it down. It makes, instead of putting like a ring in the floor, you put this, and that gives you many more options of how to strap something down.
Oh, so you're not limited to D-rings on the corners.
Correct.
Gotcha.
That are always in the wrong place.
Right.
Right. So,
because you never put anything in the corner.
Correct. And this gentleman that bought this trailer, he has no idea what he's going to use it for. It could be cars. It could be cargo. It could be sailboat fuel. And he wants to get a strap around whatever he's going to haul.
But he absolutely cannot use it as an 8-track player.
Not as an 8-track player.
All right.
Okay.
You can strap down some 8-tracks, though.
Right. That's about it.
All right.
Many of them. Players or the cassette or the whatever it's called. All right, Yuletide Farm.
Yuletide Farm.
Today?
Yep. So we were going to talk about
what time is it open today?
It's going to open at 10 o'clock today.
10?
10 o'clock.
You're opening
early. Yep.
All right, so 10 o'clock today.
Yuletide
Farm on Yuletide Lane outside of Milford.
Right, and remember we were going to talk about the movie night coming up. So it's next Saturday. That's December 10th.
Okay.
We're going to be showing The Polar Express.
Outside,
under the stars.
It.
You went
last
year.
My wife is like, he needs to do that more often.
Right. So we did. We did it a year later.
I've seen that more than once a year.
Oh, okay.
But anyway, we brought our grandkids, and it was just a good time. So we brought our kids and our grandkids.
We're going to have a food truck there.
Ooh, a food truck.
We might have two food trucks there.
Two
I don't
food
know.
Trucks.
But we're definitely
going to
have
That would be called stereo.
One.
Stereo food trucks. Go ahead.
Stereo. Okay.
Right.
So we're going to have a food truck there
once
for sure.
It's going to be mono.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then
you're gonna have a food truck there.
We're gonna have a food truck there. We're gonna have. I think we're
gonna have hot chocolate.
I don't know if the food truck will, but I think we're gonna have hot chocolate at a minimum.
Popcorn.
And Brooks is ripping
the microphone
off just to let us know there's a minute left.
About it.
I know. $500 microphone tore up with the 1 minute sign.
All right. Okay. So
scared I'll get a little more than my money's worth.
Food trucks gonna be a lot of fun, and maybe two food trucks.
Maybe, yep.
Maybe.
Yep. I think we're going to have a little crafting thing for kids before the movie. Yep. So, and that'll be...
Like somebody doing face painting?
No, I think
what
it's going to be...
Wrestling?
I think it's going to be something like maybe making a Christmas ornament or something.
Oh, that'll be cool.
I think we're
going to
have Santa there.
Oh, that'll be cool.
Right? Probably be the real one.
The real one.
Most likely.
Because he likes a good movie.
Right. Yep. All he's in it, too.
He's in it. That's true.
Yeah.
So,
he's got to see himself.
He won't be able to get his hat off afterwards. All right. So anyway, Santa's going to be there. Food trucks are going to be there.
Right.
Maybe a craft for kids.
Right. So
bring your own seat if you want.
Yeah, we're going to have straw bales set up. But
straw bales.
I recommend, if you need something with a little support on your back.
Right.
Time is up, but we're going to keep rolling just for a minute. If you need some support for your back.
Bring one with you.
Bring a chair with you, camp chair or something like
that. All right.
YuletideFarm.com. Order your tickets right now.
All right. We're back. All right. Well, anyway.
YuletideFarm.com.
Again, YuletideFarm.com. Like them on Facebook. All right. What in the world is next, Brooks Ritter? Can I do a real quick commercial for Eagle's Nest before Barry goes on?
Sure.
All right. So Barry from Dry Zone today has something really interesting to tell us. I have no idea what it is, but he does. And he promised me it was going to be one of the most interesting segments he's done so far today. So we'll see how that goes, okay? But Eagles Nest Church is the church I attend, and I really like it. Denise and I have been going there for, I don't know if it's been 12 years or 15 or 16. I guess I ought to verify that because I don't know if I'm only allowed to go there so long because it's like an endurance test for them having to put up with me. But Eagles Nest Church, I love it. We go there. Jenny goes there. Our grandkids go there. It's a really nice church. There's plenty of churches out there that are good. I'm just talking about my church, the church that I go to. Pastor Bob Weed is the pastor. And we have services on Saturday nights at 6:30 and then Sunday mornings at 9:30. One thing that Eagle's Nest is passionate about, of course, is preaching and speaking the Word of God, but also having messages that are relevant, that are in tune with what's going on right now. And that's what I have really grown to like about Eagle's Nest is I can go to church and feel like the message was just for me. And then I see somebody, they're like, no, it was just for me. And then we get into a big argument about who the message was really for. It's for everybody because Pastor Bob tries very hard to come up with messages that are timely and relevant to what's going on. Because it's real important to go to church, but it's more important that your church leaves with you, that when you go out into the community, you're the church, that you make a difference, where you go to lunch afterwards or the next stop sign or stoplight or your driving habits or anything. Everything you do, is about your witness, what people see in you, what people think, and how you cause people to react is very important. So it's called your witness. So that's what it's all about. But at Eagle's Nest, again, I really enjoy going there. But they also are very focused on kids. It's a very safe environment for your children. We know that's important. But if you have a child from birth to college, we've got something going on Saturday nights or Sunday morning for the kids. So they're not in the actual service with the parents because, you know, we want things that are relevant to the age groups of your children, and we have that. So we have Amy Brown, who heads up Kids Cove, and we have Matt Windsor, who heads up the 220 group. So anyway, it's Saturday nights at 6:30, Sunday mornings at 9:30. It's in Milton. It's right there on Zion Church Road in Milton, Delaware. Website is eaglesnest.ch. EaglesNest.ch. Also on Facebook and Twitter, it's just EaglesNestCH. And like their Facebook page if you would. If you do that right now, I'd appreciate it. I tell them that every time I talk about them, they're going to get at least 100 new likes. So if you all would do that for me, I would appreciate that. But anyway, look forward to seeing you. If you go to Eagle's Nest on Sunday morning, look me up. I'll be the vertically and follically challenged Jim Weller. In fact, at the moment, I'm the only Jim Weller going there, okay? So you can look me up. If you say, where's Jim? No, don't. You got to say Jim Weller. So anyway, is Barry here?
Barry is here.
Barry is here. Okay, are we going outside?
This is him. No.
Okay, well, come on over here and sit down. You were standing there like, Jim, I've got something very big outside for you. So I was worried because I'm not ready to go outside. It's a little chilly.
A little chilly out there.
All right, so tell me, what in the world is going on with you? I haven't seen you since Wednesday.
I know, it's been a crazy week.
It has been a crazy week. Dry Zone is just trucking on, taking care of customers, hiring help. Man.
It's a great place to
It's a whirlwind. Are you going to the party tonight?
Well, I am.
Are you really? Okay. All right, well, I want you to give us a report. What do you want him to do? Talk into the mic?
Get a little closer.
Oh, here you go. I'm closer.
All right. So anyway, I want you next week to tell me all about the equipment Mid-South Audio provided. Is that all right?
It's going to be great. We're excited to see what they have to offer for us.
Oh, you'll be very impressed with them.
I can't wait.
Okay. So anyway, Dry Zone, busy company. Do you close or anything at the end of the year for a week or two, or you just open all the time?
We're open all the time.
You even offer 24/7 emergency service.
Yes. Yeah, so if a homeowner has an issue, they can call our number and we'll get back to them and take care of the issue.
What's an issue? Got home from a trip, got water in my basement,
They watched that video on how to tighten up a pipe, and they got it solved. And all of a sudden, they come home, and they have an indoor pool.
Okay.
So they can give us a call after hours, and we'll dispatch a truck out there.
Really?
And assess the situation. If it's a new homeowner, then we can probably set up an emergency pump or something of that nature, and get an inspector out there to do it right. Because the existing homeowner will. Troubleshoot the issue and take care
of it. So you're kind of saying if you got a problem, just call us and we'll see what we can do to help you out.
Absolutely.
Okay. And what is the same number for day or night, or do you have a certain number for daylight hours and a different number?
Nope, the same one. The 684-5034.
684-5034 Dry Zone. Mm-hmm. All right. So what did you want to talk about before I so rudely interrupted you?
Just the process that when a homeowner has a concern or just a curiosity about their crawl space, basement, or foundation, the process would be they would call into the office and we'll set up the call center. We'll set up an appointment center. We'll set up an appointment. It's good for them.
Okay.
Send out a person. In the meantime, they're going to mail a packet out, a very detailed packet of information to them.
I've received that more than once.
And, of course, we want the homeowner to be educated on what is causing those problems.
Right. It was very informative.
And then the inspector will come out and do an interview with them and ask them what their concerns are and what they want to accomplish.
Would you ever go after hours to somebody's house?
Yes.
Okay, so you would be willing to accommodate their schedule?
Yes.
Okay, so it's not just 9 to 5?
No, we go, 5, 6, 7, 8 o'clock at night.
Now, what if I had a house here, but I had a vacation home in Chincoteague?
That's fine.
Really?
Yep.
All right, so you would go to Virginia.
We go down to the Bay Bridge Tunnel, the Bay Bridge, and the Delmarva Bridge.
Okay.
So we cover the whole shore.
I didn't know that, or I might have forgot that if I did know it.
Well, I did that trip to Saxis there a few weeks ago.
That's right. See how quick I forgot?
And then one of our buddies, Derek, he might be there now.
Okay.
He's on his way. He's going into the Northeast Maryland.
Really? All right. So what kind of jobs have you done this week? What is something Dry Zone has done recently?
Well, we've done some a lot of crawl spaces.
Okay.
The one that we just did the other day, the homeowner had a wet crawl space, and we showed them how to solve it with the pumps and systems.
Really?
And the crew did that one. We did some helical piers up north.
Oh, I really It's a funny word, helical beers.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's a word I use frequently, but I really want to see this or video it or something like that. So we need to bring one here and just drive that thing in the ground or something.
Well, that's the one thing I would work out with you on that. And if
right
not,
in this room,
we can do. But it's a major process. It's awesome to watch, and it's incredible to see the final product when it's all done. And it's when it's all done, you don't even know it was there because it's all covered up.
Okay. And these things are guaranteed and certified.
25 years.
That's a pretty bold statement. You know it?
25 years of future settlement.
Really? That's pretty good.
And it's backed up in writing.
Okay.
And we do commercial versions of it. We do the home. We do anything.
Oh, okay. So you do commercial work, too. I never even thought about that.
Yeah.
I always thought just homeowners.
Oh, no. We do condominiums and anything, and new construction.
Okay.
You know, some architects will have their engineers will say, hey, we want to go and put these in as a precaution because we know we're building on rough soil or challenged soil.
Right.
And they'll give us the specs that they need, and we'll have those created by our foundation department and come out and do it.
How many people works at Dry Zone?
Oh, boy. It's
20, 30?
It's around 50, I think. Just
oh,
under 50. Just under 50.
Okay, just under 50. Okay. And they're all employees. They're all regular, normal employees. They're not a whole...
Well, I might not be there with them without something.
Right. Well, I wasn't speaking from the shoulders up. I was speaking more like, are they on the payroll? And
yes.
Are they trained by Dry Zone? Or do they, when they have a job, you know, thumb through and find the cheapest subcontractor they can find?
We don't subcontract anything out but our electric.
Okay.
And that's, we have a special company that does all that for us. They might as well be our employee.
So you use one company, so
and then,
a good relationship.
Everything else is they're full-time employees year-round.
Really?
Our people, they're trained and certified by us and Basement Systems and Foundation Support Works.
Because, you know, we live in a day and time where if you called somebody to do some work, chances are they're going to bring a bunch of subs in. And then you got to, as the homeowner, worry.
Right.
Are those subs properly insured?
Well,
at least Jim Weller thinks that.
Well, I'm sure a lot of homeowners, I would. Just, you
well,
know,
I own
strangers.
Rental properties that people have had companies come and do work, and then something went wrong, and the people were not insured.
Right.
So then I'm like, well, why did you get them? Guess what their answer usually is?
They're the cheapest.
They were the cheapest. I'm like, well, didn't it make you ever wonder why were they the cheapest? What's missing? Because if somebody's cheaper than somebody else, the only person that knows what's missing is them.
Correct.
You don't know it till you need it.
Well, that's what, you know, we're fully insured and we're licensed in all three states.
You have a permanent location. And
they can come find us if they need
a
question.
You have a real phone number. You're not just giving out a bunch of cell phone numbers. You know.
And we're licensed in all the towns that we deal with because every town has their own. Oh, my.
That's another good point because you may get in there and get the job done and have a warranty claim and then the guy got ran out of town because he didn't have a business license.
Oh, yeah. Matter of fact.
It is important.
In the city of Rehoboth, I usually help out doing the final walkthroughs with the inspectors. I
do
did
you
three
really?
The other day.
Okay.
And they're and those guys are tough.
Oh, I'm sure. And you passed.
Oh, yes.
Wow. Well, very good. Very
so
good.
It's a pretty exciting place there. I mean, we're a full-service company.
But it's just steady growing.
Yes.
And you got testimonials on your website of satisfied customers time and time again.
Yes.
So it's a system, folks. In other words, I don't mean to cause people to bring you out for nothing, but I'm really personally, when I talk to people about Dry Zone, I encourage them, you have nothing to lose by calling up and saying, I'd like a home inspection.
Right.
You don't even have to think you have something wrong, do you?
No, I mean, well.
You just have to have a home.
You have to own the home.
Okay.
We do a lot we work with real estate agents and companies.
Yes. Because then it's going to come up in the inspection.
Oh, yeah. Cause,
so you might as well deal with it up front.
And the sad thing is that some homeowners don't know they have a problem until they go to sell it, and they have to fix it for the other family.
Right. They never even got the benefit of it because they were moving out.
So we do it for both, for people who are buying and selling. You
okay.
Because we usually like to say, fix it before you list it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. But so I tell people, just pick up the phone and dial 684. I forgot the number. 5034.
Yep.
Okay. 684-5034. And then just say, look, I'd like my home inspected. I mean, what? There's nothing to lose. There's no high pressure. There's no obligation.
Nope.
If they find something, you say, oh, wow, I'm glad. Because anything you find is just going to save a homeowner money eventually.
Yes.
You're either going to spend it now or you're going to spend more later.
Correct. Because, like, mold and rot.
You're not going to get away from it.
It's going to continue on, and it's a more expensive
fix
later.
Not going to fix itself.
No.
Okay.
So we're there to protect their investment.
Right.
Again, for any of those products where it's a crawl space or basement foundation. Mm-hmm. We lift concrete.
We're remodeling a basement.
We can refinish your basement.
What a great Christmas gift for somebody.
Oh, yeah, you can take a, you make it usable,
you know,
space.
Yes.
Family,
you know,
room.
We've been talking about this for years. Let's give DryZone a call, see what they can do. Same mm-hmm. thing, you use your own people. You can put up walls mm-hmm. or, you know, cover walls or put in a sump pump or insulate,
flooring.
Whatever you want done,
right.
You can do, and turn that basement into some usable, functionable, is that a word, functionable?
Functioning
it
will
space.
Be. So, yes, and they can, if you want to see the products, they can stop at our office there on Route 16.
You really do welcome people to just stop
yes.
in. Okay, I just...
And it was Bill and I were talking about it. He was just amazed at how many people do stop in.
How many people do? Well, all roads lead to DryZone.
Okay, exactly.
Sooner or later.
And then they can see the wall systems we use. We have the pumps on display, the flooring.
I want to see the helio, whatever they're called.
Helical piers. We have one of those on display.
Oh, you do?
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
Someday,
not as easy to move around.
Somehow, we need to see if we can drill one out in the ground out here.
Oh, we just keep...
And see if we hit oil or the phone line. Or the fiber optic line.
Oh, well, oil will be good.
Oil will be good. Yeah, let's stick
not
with
a
oil,
tank.
Right?
Not a tank,
yeah, not a tank. Not a tank. This used to be a gas station.
I can see that drilling out there. Hit oil. Oh, yes, we hit it.
Where
big.
Where are these sparks coming from? You said there was no tanks here, Jim.
Yeah, we do have Miss Utility or somebody.
Okay, that's
mark
a good
those
idea.
Things.
There's no tanks out here. There may be some 55-gallon drums, but there's no tanks, Barry. I'm just kidding, everybody. I'm just kidding. I really am kidding.
Denrek, turn it off. No.
No, I think Denrek's... They're on the way anyway. Oh, here's the big green truck with all the lights.
But
oh,
no,
where'd they get that trailer?
Well, that would
okay,
be exciting. We'll have to set that up because we can get the excavator out here.
Yeah.
And then just some other things that we've been doing.
Yeah, we should record that show. We should do it live.
Oh, I saw that.
Oh, yeah.
Some of the other things that we do is, like, right now we're a collection spot. We're an unofficial collection spot for Code Purple.
Oh, my gosh. What did you donate? 300 pounds of stuff so far?
Yes, and it's growing again, so we're excited to see how this turns out for the Christmas run.
Did you know it was 300 pounds of stuff?
No, we just we had dropped it off to First Avenue Church in Milford.
What did they tell you? How much it weighed?
Well, he... Cliff had posted it on Facebook, and
okay.
all of a sudden that's where they showed it, so I guess he must have waited or something.
Was there a lot of canned goods?
Not really. There was a whole mixture of stuff. A lot of socks. Yeah, all the socks we got from you, we sent them right on up.
Wow, very good. All right.
So it was pretty exciting to do that. And
So you're right this minute. People could still stop by DryZone. It's not an unofficial thing you're doing.
Yes.
Started out doing it just with your own employees.
It was our employees that did it.
It turned out to be way more successful than you thought.
Correct.
And so you're like, what the heck? We got a convenient location.
And I talked about, Bill said it was okay to invite everybody over and drop off your donations.
All right, so if you want to drop off some items, I'm going to describe a Code Purple situation
yes.
as best I can. I believe Code Purple is certain locations throughout Delaware mm-hmm. that have already been designated as places that people that maybe don't stay in a place, people that, I won't call them homeless, but some people just would rather stay outside than inside.
Mm-hmm.
But they can go to any one of these facilities
mm-hmm.
at a moment's notice if the temperature drops below a certain temperature.
Correct.
And it's no charge or anything. But these places always need toiletries, canned goods, blankets, gloves, mm-hmm. hats, scarves, and socks.
Absolutely.
And bars of soap, probably.
And we're an unofficial location, and we'll then forward it to the correct place.
Okay, so this is just something nice that you guys decided
mm-hmm.
to do.
Yeah.
And it all started, you just did it with your own employees, and you're like, well, we rounded up 300 pounds of stuff. What could we do if we allowed the public to
Absolutely.
Drop stuff off?
I was amazed.
That's very nice of you
yeah.
to take up your time and your energy to deal with this. Uh-oh, something's happening. Your head started glowing.
Had a glare.
Let me tip my head this way.
But the so all yeah, right. it's something fun we're doing and give back to the community. And some other fun things we're going to be in. We're going to have one of our trucks in, like, the Rehoboth Christmas Parade and the Milton Christmas
really?
Parade.
Okay,
yeah.
The big DryZone truck?
Yep, the big lift truck.
All right, so folks, if you're out there, tell DryZone you heard about him at Weller Does Delmarva. Say, hey, Barry, you won't even be in there, will you?
I won't be driving it.
All right, then.
Whoa.
Oh, that was great.
Good morning.
All right. Good morning, sunshine. All right.
Okay.
Right, the sun is up. All right, anything else?
Just that, you know, we're looking for more great, happy, fun people to come work for us.
Are you really?
Yes.
There's no stopping you guys.
I'm even been told that I can have an assistant, so I need
no kidding.
Looking for somebody in the marketing department. We got people in other departments, so just
really?
Go to careers to dryzone.com and
fill out an app.
Fill out an app and go from there.
Marketing department. Wow. So that would interest me, but I don't have time. I don't think you could take the pressure. They'd be like, oh, my gosh, you hired an expert on everything? So.
Right. And it.
I only wanted a marketing helper. I didn't want somebody who knew it all. Brooks liked that, didn't he?
He did. He got a group kick out of that.
He almost could relate to it.
But, yeah, so, you know, it's kind of, it's a fun place to work. It's lots of new challenges.
You're certainly growing.
Oh, it's crazy. I love it.
I've been dealing with you 3-4 years now, and I've just been proud to watch the growth, in other words, and got all these nice vehicles, and they're all lettered up, and your employees look good, and got a nice location there on Route 16 in Ellendale.
It's a very organized
very
and
professional.
Fun. Yes.
Yeah, not just a cell phone number, and you wonder what they're going to show up in today.
Right. I mean, it's a process. The homeowner, there's no surprises along the way.
None. All right. I agree. Barry, I'm going to leave you. You want to give out the website?
Yep, dryzone.com.
Okay.
That's open 24 hours.
All right.
And then they can visit us at the location on Beach Highway on 16.
Okay. And or, phone number?
Or 684-5034.
Still pushing that same number.
Oh, yeah.
All
Keep
right.
it easy.
Are you working today?
I just did.
Really?
I'm done for the rest of the day.
He's exhausted.
I wore out.
This was like an endurance test.
Now I got to get all my cameras ready for tonight.
Okay. It's going to be a lot of fun. Have a good time.
It's going to be great. Thank you.
All right. I'll see y'all. Thank you, Barry. Dryzone.com, folks. Dryzone.com. All right. What is the next thing I want to talk about? Did I talk about Eagle's Nest Church? I think I did.
You did, yes. Yep.
How about Wilson's Auction? Have I talked about them?
You have not.
Man, guess what today is?
Today is Saturday, which means there's probably an auction, right?
Every Saturday right there on Route 113 in Lincoln City, Delaware, Wilson's Auction. But guess what else today? Taylor and Messick in Harrington is their big annual December consignment auction. So go on to Lincoln. Now, Lincoln starts at 10 this morning and goes into the evening, and there's all kinds of stuff there. But at Taylor and Messick in Harrington, this is their annual December consignment auction. Tractors and tillage equipment and planters and hay equipment and combine heads and lawn and garden stuff. So there's something for the homeowner. There's something for the contractor. There's something for the farmer. There's something for everybody. And that starts at 9 o'clock today. So it's starting anytime. So I just want to tell you, you can go there. Tuesday night's the auto auction right there at Wilson's in Lincoln. So that's at 6 o'clock every Tuesday night. And if you want something sold, Wilson's Auction can turn it into cash. If you want to buy something, it's a great place to buy stuff. They've been serving our community now for over 40 years. So Dave Wilson and his team, I highly recommend them. I deal with them. I like them. I've bought stuff from them. I've sold stuff through them. And they're just good people. Going to give you the phone number real quick. And they have a real nice New Year's Day auction, too, so you might want to make plans to go to that. 422-3454, 422-3454, or on the web, it's wilsonsauction.com. So today in Lincoln and in Harrington at Taylor and Messick. Brooks, what did you think of all that dry zone talk?
That's pretty amazing. They got a lot
Dr.
of really...
T's here. He stuck his head in the door. So we're going to talk to Dr. T about chiropractic care, massage, wellness. It's like a total wellness center down there, and I think both you and Brandon are very happy customers. I know I am.
Absolutely.
And I love dealing with them. So can I talk real quick about my accountant too?
Sure.
It's the end of the year. We're doing our tax planning and getting everything straight. I did have some really, really good news. You know, I bought the Surf Digitag number one, and I paid $26,000, and they evidently say that anything beyond $250 is considered a donation, which would be $25,750, and it absolutely, according to my accountant, is a donation. So that helps me. That helps the state parks, of course, and it's kind of neat. So if you want one of those low-digit surf fishing tags and you buy them, they are considered a donation, but ask your own tax person to double-check. But that made the tag even much more affordable. So, yes, I'm happy that I bought the tag. I'm going to resell it at some point, but for now, I'm going to sit on it for a few years. All right, so can I go back to my accountant? George Luff is who gave me all that advice. Actually, his son Tyler, to be exact. But anyway, I deal with Luff & Associates. I deal with them for all my accounting, but I also deal with them for my payroll. And if you're listening and you own a business, you know how annoying and frustrating payroll can be. So if you're looking for somebody to give you a hand with your payroll, okay, whether you want them to do a little bit or all of it, they can help you out. You say, well, I've only got 4 or 5 employees. That's fine. You can have 2 employees and they'll help you, or you can have hundreds and they'll help you. So if you need an accounting firm, they can help you with that. But even if you don't deal with them for your accounting and you want to use them for your payroll, you can also do that. It's called Luff and Associates, and I'm going to give you a phone number because they have three locations, Milford and Dover and Rehoboth. But one phone number will get you to everywhere, and it's 422-9699. 422-9699 is the number, and on the web it's luffcpas.com. You give them a call, tell them I sent you. They'll take good care of you, whether you need an accountant, whether you have some tax-related issues, or whether you just want them to do your payroll. They'll help you out. All right, we are going to talk to Dr. T after the 8 o'clock break. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Barry really has got a lot cooking. Dry Zone is quite a company. And I just want to let you know that Weller's is going to be open, probably open by now, but in another 6 minutes for sure. We open early on Saturdays at 8 o'clock, and Brooks will be in sales by about what time?
Probably about 9:30-ish.
And Brandon, he'll be over there probably in 15, 20 minutes. Is that right?
Well, he's got another spot in the 8:30 hour.
Oh, so we can talk more with Brandon.
Yes.
So he'll be laying more stuff up here after Dr. T, and we'll be talking more.
Yep.
Okay. All right. Well, anyway, Brandon and Brooks happen to be brothers. They've both been with me for years. They do a great job. There is quite a little tension slash rivalry between the two of them because they are commission salesmen and they only get paid on what they sell. They keep trying to talk me into just paying both of them on everything we sell. But Earl's not going to stand for that. So we have Earl. I don't know if Earl will be in today, but he's doing real good from what I understand. And he'll be back to work hopefully next week. I don't know. Brandon's on vacation. So Brooks will be getting it all. Brooks and Earl.
Works for me.
Terry and Jason. So anyway, got a lot going on.
We do.
Weller's Utility Trailers will be open today at 8 o'clock. Is that right?
Yes.
And phone number there at the store is 337-8228, 337-8228. The website is wellers.com. Our discount cards, are they on the front of the website yet?
They're not.
Okay, so they'll be on there, we'll say, by Monday afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
If you haven't got one yet, you can't because they're not in yet. That's probably why they aren't on the website.
Yeah.
But I want to let people know what's on them. So Brooks will put them on the website, give you a heads up on that. I did post it one day on Facebook, and I guess we could do a Facebook post later today. But our new discount card has got some really good businesses on it with some really amazing discounts. So I want you to take a look at it. We don't have them. We'll have them by the 15th, hopefully. They're going to make a great, great, great Christmas gift, and we lowered the price. They used to be $15. Now they're going to be $10, and I don't remember the specials, but there is some specials also where if you buy more than one, you get a little bit of a discount. So that's kind of the gift that keeps on giving, but I don't have them yet. So anyway, that's that. But we have a lot of different things, and when we go to the website, wellers.com, we can see some of the different ads. What does it say? Click on current ads or
current ads, yep.
Current specials or something like that. And we have all kinds of interesting things. We have vehicle air fresheners, five of them for a dollar. I think they used to be a dollar a piece. We're now selling them five for a dollar. We've got a bunch of T-shirts, crazy, Bubba Gump and other miscellaneous T-shirts. And they're like $7 for 10. No, $10 for seven. $10 for seven shirts. That's pretty cheap. Then I don't know how I got these, but we have wooden hangers. These are brand new hangers, and they're wooden. So they're kind of nice. If the electric goes out, you could always use them to start a fire and keep yourself warm, preferably not inside the house or the closet. But anyway, we have wooden hangers, 27 cents each. I don't know where that price come from, but that's pretty cheap, 27 cents. But speaking of cheap, 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 are they right here? These extension cords. This is a 25-foot heavy-duty extension cord. It is 16-gauge, okay? Heavy-duty outdoor extension cord for not $20, not $15, not even $10, $8.75. Who in their right mind sells extension cords for $8.75? Nobody can touch that price. Contractors, beware. We've got the deal on extension cords. If you don't have enough for your Christmas tree or Christmas lights, we got them. I'll be back in just a minute with more on the radio. Stick with me right here on Facebook Live. Is that what it's called? Facebook
yes,
Live?
Facebook Live.
Okay, and we're also at WellerDoesDelmarva.com. We're also on My Cozy TV, so we're everywhere. And anyway, so Colin, you want to come over and we talk again about the Missipillion paddle boat that's coming? It's going to be breaking news.
Wow, this is a surprise. I can't wait to hear about this. Go ahead.
I think that there is talk of a paddle boat coming to Milford.
Really?
And they're going to have it go up and down the Missipillion River between those two bridges. Which ones I mean?
The one, the drawbridge, sure. And then
not even that far, just between those two.
Oh, you're talking about the Washington Street Bridge, right, and then the footbridge?
Yes, the footbridge. Wow. That's it. It's going to be a small paddle boat.
Maybe
it might be remote controlling operated.
It might be.
Okay, can we get on to something serious? You keep bringing up these
I know,
things.
I know. I wish you'd hurry
What's
up.
What's going on?
So we're going to talk about Yuletide Farm a little
Again?
Bit. Yep. So it's a Christmas tree farm.
How much can you talk about Yuletide Farm?
I don't know. If Brooks keeps the signs down,
up.
We can't talk a whole lot if he keeps
All
them
right.
up.
Go.
So, Yuletide Farm, it's a Christmas tree farm. We're just outside of Milford. Actually, right. It's, you know, Milford address, and it's just outside of city limits.
Just go over the overpass on Route 36.
That's right.
Just a couple roads down, just a little bit down. Walking distance.
Walking distance, yeah. It's, right. I think we're the fourth place on the left there.
And then there's a lane called Yuletide Lane.
Yep.
That just coincidentally matches right up to Yuletide Farm.
It does. That's
it's
right.
It's amazing.
It is amazing.
I mean,
it's like it almost planning. Like it was planned.
What planning that was. All right. So anyway, you got Christmas trees.
That's right. We have
got
Christmas trees. We have plenty left. Yep.
Hundreds?
Hundreds left.
Okay,
yep.
Okay, here we go.
We brought 300 in. So,
did you really?
Yeah, we did.
Whole tractor trailer boat.
Yep.
I know. It wasn't a whole
It wasn't a full tractor. The guy
okay.
was...
But it was a tractor trailer.
Yeah, it was okay. a tractor trailer.
All right. So anyway, you got them for sale.
We do. We have them for sale.
You're
and
not renting them or anything.
No. We actually don't want them back when you're done with them.
Oh, so you want people to keep them?
That's right.
Them.
To keep them.
Okay.
Exactly.
All right.
And yeah. So I mean, we've got five. We've got like five, I think, or six different varieties.
Okay. Do you have any Douglas firs?
We have Douglas fir.
Fraser fir. Okay.
Keep coming. Come on.
Harry fir.
No. Okay. Conifer.
Conifer. All right. So you have Douglas fir.
We have Douglas fir. We All have right. Concolor or Conkler.
I was hoping you would have Conkler.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
We've got.
I didn't know.
It's only one.
Who was going to have them anyway?
We have Canaan.
What?
Canaan. Yep.
Abel.
Yeah. Canaan Abel. Yep. Yep. One of them's dying.
I'm sure your mic's off when you're laughing over this. Very serious show.
Yeah. And
very professional.
We have, did we say Fraser? We said Fraser, didn't
All
we?
I remember was Douglas fir.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. We are burning up a lot of time.
A lot of
Come
time.
And see what we have.
Are people
Most people don't know the name of them anyway.
Do they want to stop by and just look around?
Absolutely. Stop by, look around. Check
you
out the gift shop. I think we have
call
the
it
nice.
Gift stop. I call it a
gift shop.
I call it a store.
Yeah, it's a store
okay.
in a tent, and it's a big, it's a
but
20
tent
by 40
windows.
Tent. It has windows.
Very
it has
nice
heat.
Tent.
And it has carpet.
That's right. And it has a nice front door.
A glass front door. That's
a
right.
Glass front it's, door, carpet, windows,
that's,
and heat.
That's our
tent.
Foyer.
Foyer.
You didn't notice the
you need
foyer
a chandelier
area?
For in there.
We've got two chandeliers in there.
You're kidding me.
I am not kidding. There's two chandeliers.
Oh, real quick, tell them. You can come next Saturday. We're going to do the show there.
Oh, we are going to do the show
we
there.
We are going to do the show there.
As long as everything works out technically.
Right. Okay.
You got to check on that. But,
right.
yeah.
but anyway, so, all right. It was good.
Yeah. YuletideFarm.com and Yuletide Farm on Facebook.
Turn it right side up.
And, time now okay. time is up. No, time okay. is down now. Now time
okay.
is up.
All right.
There you go.
Okay, YuletideFarm.com, Yuletide Farm on Facebook.
Right.
Right outside of Milford on Route 36. You open tomorrow?
We're open tomorrow, same hours, 10 to 5. 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Yeah.
Yep.
Get out there. Get out there.
Get out there and get a tree.
Look, in the Christmas tree
if
business.
If one's not big enough, buy two.
In the Christmas tree business, you've got about 5 weeks of the year to make your money.
Well, no, because they become collector's items after Christmas.
Yeah, okay.
It goes up.
Yeah, we need to have lots of remotes out there to sell them after Christmas.
After, yeah.
Yeah.
We'll be there every day. It'll be a marathon.
Yeah, yep.
All right, YuletideFarm.com.
That's
All
right.
right.
Thank you.
Good?
You. Yeah, I'm good.
All right,
yep.
thank you, sir.
But think about that, 5 weeks out of the year to make your money.
I agree, that's it. Must be a lot of money in selling Christmas.
That is a sprint. That's not a marathon. That's a sprint.
A sprint.
Yeah.
All right. So anyway, Weller's is open. Phones are on, 337-8228, Weller's.com on the web. Got a lot of things to tell you about and talk to you about, and we appreciate you watching the show on My Cozi TV. Also, if you would, you can watch it later at WellerDoesDelmarva.com if you feel you missed something, and also you can watch it on Facebook Live now or later. So anyway, Brooks is going to be in sales about 9:15. Brandon's going to be in sales probably by 9 o'clock. The store is open, and Jason and Terry are over there. Is that right?
Right,
just Jason.
Just Jason. Yep.
Oh my gosh!
But
he'd be easy pickings to make a deal with. What?
Absolutely.
What? Absolutely. There's nobody to protect him from giving away the farm. All right, so it's just Jason over there. All right, well, I'll do the next segment by myself. How about that? After Brandon's done with all the pictures and autograph signing and everything, we'll just cut him loose. So Brandon and Jason are going to be over there, but Brandon will take your call right this minute. 542, huh? He's already got one this morning. 542-7794. 542-7794. Brandon Ritter is ready for your call right this minute. Let's give out Jason's cell phone number, too. All right? 542, is it 7233?
Yeah.
542-7233. I need somebody to call Jason right now and say, I heard you're giving away bags of widgets, and I want one. Okay? And we'll see what he does with that conversation. All right? And it's a large bag. Okay? So it's a large bag of widgets. And also, we're giving away trailers full of sailboat fuel. The sailboat fuel's free. You got to buy the trailer or bring your own, and you can load your own. Oh, I know something he can give away free that's real legitimate here. Styrofoam cubes.
Mm-hmm.
Do we have any left?
We sure do.
All right, so if you want some styrofoam cubes, and nothing will make you a bigger fan at the Christmas party, if you get one of these styrofoam cubes and you wrap it up and you give it as, you know, like how businesses exchange gifts, and tell us how, in fact, you do that, and we'll let you on the show to tell us how that went. All right? Or give one to your loved one. All right? So come on in to Jason, 542-7233. You call him now and say, hey, I want one of those. And they're collectible items. They're very rare. You cannot get them at every place that sells trailers. They're rather hard to find. What are we on the radio now? We're back on the radio, folks. So you're listening to Weller Does Delmarva. We are live everywhere. And if you thought you missed something, because you did, if you thought you missed something, go to Jim Weller on Facebook, because we're streaming live. You can go back and watch the show later, or WellerDoesDelmarva.com. Why don't we get our next guest on? What do you think of that?
I think that sounds like a great idea.
He's dressed very well. This is a young man I've grown to know and like. He's got his socks on. He's looking good, and we're going to introduce him to you. Come on down and have a seat. Watch your step. We're fully insured, but we don't want you to trip. I think your claim would be bigger than others.
I know a good dog.
All right, so grab the mic and hold on tight and get ready. You have to hold it because it's like jumper cables. There's a positive and negative.
Oh, boy.
So, you know, you got to ground out with it. But anyway, good morning to you, Dr. T.
Good morning, gang, and I want to apologize. I did stop the T.S. Smith's, just so you know, but the donuts are not done until after 8.
You're kidding me.
So I tried to bring you donuts.
So we're going to see you twice today is what you're saying.
Double the fun.
Double the fun. All right. So, Peninsula Chiropractic Center. You've been in business a long time.
Yes.
40, 50, 60 years?
At least, or 100. Over 30.
Over 30.
Yes.
And you're the owner-operator, and you got Dr. Bud in there with you?
Dr. Bud is with us, although he's out golfing this morning, and I'm here.
Really?
Yes.
All right. Well, he's probably listening to you on
the cell
phone.
Yes, he told me he was going to. Hey, Doc.
Okay. Dr. Bud. All right. So, anyway, good morning.
Good morning.
So, Peninsula Chiropractic Center, I would describe it more not just chiropractic care. I mean, starting with the initial phone call, you could tell the people that work there care. You show a genuine interest in people's situations. So, you know, from making the initial appointment to meeting with one of the docs to finding out if their insurance is covered properly or if they have insurance or don't, to a massage or some therapeutic care. It's a wellness center.
Yes, exactly.
But starting with the initial phone call, everybody there seems to embrace the fact that the customer is the one that matters here.
We've tried to promote that healing is not just about when they see the doc, but it starts from the first call, on down. So, yes, that's our mission is to try to make that happen.
I've had it personally where I would call and they're interested in what I'm experiencing or what I'm dealing with. And I've explained how business is off and customers aren't coming in. And they're like, well, we can't help you with that, but we can help you feel better. In other words, we can help you handle the stress better. So anyway, but I've loved dealing with you guys. And I mean, I have had a certain amount of medical issues anyway.
Sure.
And not all medical facilities are as accommodating. I like it. So,
well, as I said, we try to teach people. There's a lot of people come to us who have never seen a doctor of chiropractic before.
So
they have very nervous. And so, you know, we try to calm the waters. And again, we have different adjustments for different people. I don't adjust my children when they were born, literally when they came out of the womb. I started checking their spine and adjusting them from that day right on up to the world's strongest drug-free powerlifter. So, okay. And everything in between. So the techniques are all different. They're different depending on someone may be fully grown in a regular adjustment, but they've had some type of injury or setback. So we may adjust them like we would a five-year-old. So okay. It depends on the purpose. It's not a one-size-fits-all.
Wow. And you're rather experienced, I mean, because you've been in business quite a while. I mean, you went to probably a lot of college first.
Yes, it takes, you know, around 8 or 9 years, depending on if you have undergraduate. But today, medical school and chiropractic school is the same length of time. The difference is after the diagnosis. Medicine has three basic choices: to give you a drug or inject you or cut you. And chiropractic said, let's look at the natural approach first. Body has the ability of healing itself. And I want to say we've had five different medical physicians work with us over the years in the office that, you know, refer to us a lot because they understand that let's save surgery. I mean, unless you've been thrown through a car windshield, but save surgery till the very last. But we do, you know, we will refer you out to other medical specialists if that's needed.
But you know your expertise and you also know your limits.
Yes.
You know, and I like that. And that's where we have mentioned the free meet and greet consultation, more or less. In other words, you have offered that if somebody mentions Weller Does Delmarva or Jim Weller, that they literally can have a one-on-one with either you or Dr. Bud to determine if what they're experiencing is something that you feel you can help them with.
Exactly, because a lot of people don't know what, you know, for example, they don't understand that we might work on extremities.
Right.
You may have a low back problem, but it may be because the ankle or foot is misaligned. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we talk about that, and we like to, you know, educate, motivate, then activate the client into a health and wellness
state. But, I mean, that's a wonderful offer because normally, you would go in, you would either pay a copay or a deductible or whatever, then meet with the doc to find out that particular doctor isn't going to be able to. You know, and even in your case, it's a matter of, do the personalities click?
Yes, and also, that's a great point, that all the visits, you know, where a physician's office is set up is that everything is a fee.
Right.
I like it when a lot of people say, you know, my doc was really great when I was in the hospital. He stuck his head in and said hi. Mm-hmm. I said, well, make sure you check your bill because that hi costs you X number of dollars.
Right.
You know,
right.
So it's, yes, we take our time to do that because we find it pays back when we can educate people a little bit about can we help them. And I've had people, I haven't, not many, but a few that I've had to refer out immediately. And when we do that, those people have actually referred people back to me because they said, if he can't help you, he'll send you to the people.
Open and honest.
We just had a lady, 83, who's been to several different physicians, and it was elusive what was going on with her, but I actually set her up with a neurologist, and we found she had two brain tumors that no one had picked up, and no one had sent her in that direction. And she just came in last week to thank us. She said no one else has taken the time to send her to do that. So.
That's,
you know,
a good one.
Yeah. So just recently that's happened, yeah.
Wow. Well, very good. Thank you for being so attentive to detail. I mean, in other words, to listening to her.
Well, we find
not that, listening at yeah. her, but listening yeah. to her.
You yeah, know? Speak with and not to people, I
Correct.
Find, becomes important.
Correct. Well, you're kind of a family-oriented business. Your wife is very involved with the business. You're there. You're hands-on. You're an owner-operator. You're Sussex County, and you care. You know, in other words, and so you can see it. Your people, I mean, I'm not just bragging on any one of them, every one of them. I mean, from the first calling, just even if I've got something and I'm not feeling right or I just want to get squeezed in or whatever, they're like, what works for you? And we'll see if it works for us. And if it doesn't, we'll make it work for us. And I've really, really appreciated that. And thank I've tried you. Not to abuse it.
Oh, no. Yeah. I mean, you guys have been awesome to us. And, you know, I want to thank you. And I hope my team is not listening because then they'll want to raise because they have just... Without them, and that's what, it, for all businesses, when they get that, that's what it makes America great. It's not just the leader of the team. It's not the quarterback of the game, but it's the entire team.
Correct.
And I am so blessed to have such a great, multifaceted team. Dr. Bud just does I couldn't have picked a better doc to work with me. So we've got an awesome team. Give us a
you
call.
Want to name names?
No, I don't. No, I don't, Tiffany. Thank you. So, but anyway... We've got a great group of people.
What's your holiday hours?
Our holiday hours are the same. We're going to be there on Friday, you know, just before Christmas.
Okay.
We'll probably be off Christmas, our Christmas Monday, that Monday will be
okay.
closed.
We are too.
But other than that, everything else is normal. But if you forget, don't worry about it. Always someone, as you know, most all hours of the day
amazing.
And night will answer
you
or return your call.
You can leave a message at 8 or 9 o'clock at night and get a phone call back.
Yes, we like that personal touch.
629-4344 is the number. Because I'm going to guess the holiday season is a little stressful for people.
Yes.
Or they got family members coming home from college or something like that, and they need to get in or get adjusted or whatever. And the massages. I know this. I'm really putting you on the spot.
Yes.
Now.
Okay, here we go.
You ready?
Yep.
Can you get massage gift certificates?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, I wasn't positive.
Yes,
that.
We absolutely
okay.
can. And we do a lot of those. And it's quite frankly, I've had even my own clients forget that, and when I say, you know, because, you know, you get a certain age, you have everything you need pretty much.
Correct.
And I say, well, you know, check your family about a massage therapy. Oh, yeah, that's a great idea. And they'll
even
send their families
employer.
In. Yeah,
an employer or, wanting something for the employees.
That's a great idea. Something
because
they can
the
really
employer
use.
Could be the employee's pain in the neck.
No names mentioned.
Yes.
Yeah, no comment.
Okay. Or it could be the other way around.
It could be the other way around.
The employees
absolutely.
Could buy their boss a gift certificate.
That
for
door
a massage.
Swings two ways.
Right. So anyway, just don't let it hit you, right?
Either way.
But what we're saying is you can get a gift certificate for a massage.
Yes.
And they are really nice. And, you know, and another one more thing on the massage is I remember I was having a lot of trouble with the shoulder, and then I got some massages,
yes.
but you or Dr. Bud would explain
mm-hmm.
what you wanted them to do. So it wasn't like, oh, you get the adjustment over here, and you get the massage over here, and nobody's communicating
right.
in between. You communicate with each other, and that's kind of like
yes.
a wellness. You know,
exactly
you're working
right.
in conjunction with.
Yes.
I'm trying my best to make you look good here.
You are doing a great job. I appreciate that.
All right. And we're very happy. I'm happy. My wife's happy. I do always tell the story about my granddaughter, how, you know, she hears a little better after she's adjusted, you know. So still can't get her to hear clean her room.
Yeah.
No, I'm just playing.
Selective
she's
hearing.
Very good. Yeah, selective hearing. All right, 629-4344 is the number.
Yes.
You're on Facebook. They can
yes.
get gift certificates. You're on the web also. So it's peninsulacairocenter.com. Anything
yes.
else?
Just we are doing our Christmas toy drive again.
Okay.
We are drop off. So we've done this for 30 years now. And I think last year, Ginny Short, we tied in with the Seaford Blades Associated Charities.
Excellent.
Said there was probably 50 families would not have Christmas. But thanks to you guys out there.
Excellent.
I mean, we have patients, but we also had people just stop in and actually
drop
as
off.
A drop off. So please, you know, help us help them. We appreciate that. It's an exciting project that we do. Just a side note, if you're interested in any type of fitness programs, call us about those. We'll be talking
okay.
about those with Jim more in the new year.
All right. Anything else?
Thank you much. You guys are awesome. Have a great new year, and I probably won't see you in here until next year.
That's right.
So thank you much for everything you've done
okay.
for us, and
thank
have a
you.
Great, great new year.
All right. We appreciate
you
and your friendship. Thank
appreciate
you very
brother.
Much.
Have a good one.
Okay. All right. So that was Dr. T, Peninsula Chiropractic Center, and 629-4344. I personally highly recommend them. I'm a very satisfied customer, and I think you will be too. All right, what is next? You going to talk about no nonsense or talk some nonsense? Which would you rather do there, Mr. Ritter?
No nonsense sounds better.
No nonsense?
Yes.
Rick Fowler, another good supporter of the show, good friend
absolutely.
Of ours, and a great place to do business, folks. I got to say this, you know, before I get deep in his commercial, anybody you hear on this show, you can rest assured we've tried them out. We've dealt with them. We've done business with them. We've known them for years, you know. And so all of our advertisers are people that I do business with or somebody associated to me does and that we like them right down to Colin Walls and Walls Service Center and Yuletide Farm and so on. So if you hear them here, you can rest assured we've already checked them out for you. But No Nonsense Office Machines is a great place to go shopping between now and Christmas because if you're thinking about a tablet, or you're thinking about a computer or a laptop, or maybe a gaming system, or you need something fixed, or you want to get something but you can't afford new, but you want to know has he got a good deal on a laptop. He's got a good deal on a laptop. He's got a good deal on a tablet. Now, if you're a parent or a grandparent, here's what you need to know when you go in there. If you're buying something for your kids or your grandkids, he's going to ask you their age. Because Rick has got so much experience in selling stuff, he knows what ages are going to be more focused on, especially if it's gaming and things like that. So, you know, if you have a little kid, they're going to use it for certain things. If you got a teenager, they're going to use it for something else. I know my son, for example, when it came to buying cell phones, he always wanted them with, I forgot the numbers, 100 and some gigabytes or something like that. Mm-hmm. And I'm happy with nothing like that. And I'm like, why is that? Because he would always put his music in his phone. So yeah. Really mattered to him, in other words, you know. So something I personally experienced. So if you're looking for something, whether it be office equipment, maybe you own a business and you need a copier or something like that, Rick deals with offices as well as consumers. And, you know, you go in some of these places that sell electronic stuff and they talk to you in a language you don't even understand. You go down there to no-nonsense office machines and every one of his staff will talk to you in a way that you can understand. They help you through the process of buying something or getting something fixed or something like that. Been around a long time. They service what they sell, conveniently located just 2 miles east of the Circle in Georgetown on Route 9, right a couple doors down from Sports at the Beach Complex. Phone number is, ready? 856-7381. 856-7381. You can look him up on Facebook, Richard Fowler, or No Nonsense Office Machines. You actually could send him a question in the evening, and sometimes he'll answer it in the evening. In fact, if you're watching on Facebook, WellerDoesDelmarva.com, or MyCozy TV, there is his ad right there. So give him a call. Tell him I sent you. Let me real quick speak of advertising. If you're watching and you see that ad, I call it a sliver. I think Colin calls it a lower third or something like that. But anyway, ads like that are for sale during this show if you want to talk about that. All right, what is next, Brooks?
I just got a message.
Okay, well,
from Brandon. He said from Brandon, he went over to help Jason over there.
Yes.
And he said we actually had a holdy pole customer right at 8 o'clock. From hearing it on the show.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Okay, folks, does advertising work?
Yes,
do you want to make $3.75 in a day?
Yes.
Advertise with me. I'll get you customers. Wow, is that amazing or what?
Yeah. Just tells you how it works.
But them holdy poles are a neat item too, though, aren't they?
They are. They're one of a kind. Yep.
Can I go back to the extension cords, or did you have something on your mind?
You can keep rolling.
Okay, so you had nothing on your mind. Okay.
Lots on the mind.
I got a good deal on these extension cords. They're brand spanking new. They're heavy duty, so they're outdoor extension cords. But can you use an outdoor extension cord indoor?
Absolutely.
You can?
Sure.
You just can't do the opposite.
I wouldn't use one that's meant for the indoors outdoors.
Right. All right. So anyway, we have 15-foot ones. Now, very limited supply on these, but if you're listening and you're a contractor or you're going to put up a lot of Christmas lights or you're just tired of not having enough extension cords, because this is a great gift for anybody. You got somebody, you don't know what to get them, there isn't a soul that can't use another extension cord.
Yeah, you can put it in their stocking.
Yeah, there you go.
It could be a stocking stuffer.
And we got the stockings.
Sure.
So anyway, 15-foot extension cord, $5.75.
Mm-hmm.
Now, 25-foot, $8.75. 50-foot, listen to this one, $14.75 for a 50-foot extension cord. 100-footer, you would be thinking $35, $40, $25.
That's 25 cents a foot.
$25 for a 100-foot, 16-gauge extension cord. Okay? Anyway, we got them. It's an outdoor quality cord. And they're ready to go. So if you need any from 15-foot to 100-foot, supply is extremely limited. If you're listening from out of state, of course, there's no sales tax unless you insist. And then you can just tip us an extra 6 or 7 or 9.5%, whatever makes you feel comfortable. This gizmo here, I don't know if you've ever used it, Brooks, or not, but I've watched it be used. It's a drill bit sharpener. And it's really kind of a cool item. You just take a drill bit that's dull, and you just put it in the appropriate sizes here. They're all listed there. And you just put it down in there, and it will somehow, miraculously, resharpen that bit.
That's pretty neat.
It's pretty neat. Now, I don't have many of them, and I'm thumbing through the ads to see how much it is, but it's another great gift idea. I do have something else I want to mention, but these are $15, and if you look around, they're probably $25 or $30 normally. Again, we are just liquidating so much stuff between now and the end of the year. So when you hear the prices, I don't want you to be alarmed. Some of them are truly below what they should be. Okay, they're just really good deals. Speaking of that, I need to tell you, you may not even know this yet, Brooks, but I have put some generators on sale well below dealer cost.
Really?
For example, we have a 4,375 watt Briggs & Stratton generator. All right. And these are listed on our website. The sale prices are there. So they can go two places. They can go to the generators or they can go to the ads, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So anyway, and you'll see the sale prices either place. But you got a Briggs & Stratton 4,375-watt generator, brand new in the box. This thing here has a price normally of $439. I've got it discounted down to $347. Now think about that. That's a name brand, not a no-name brand, but a name brand generator, $347. I've got a 6,250-watt Briggs & Stratton generator, has a list price of $899. I've reduced it more than 40%, $500 even. So contractors, you know that one's a good deal. And on top of that, if you buy a generator and you can come back later or the next day, we will take it out of the box. We will put it together, put the wheels on it for you. We will put a little bit of gas in it. We will put oil in it. And all that service is no charge. So we will do that for you. So you don't even have to be bothered with buying the oil. We'll put the oil in. We will fuel it up, not completely, but enough to get it running. And we'll put the wheels on it and the handle on it and so on. We will start it up. We will let it run. We will plug plugs into the plugs. So that way you know it's good and you don't have to be bothered with that when you get ready to use it or when you get home. You can grab it, go get a bite to eat. Maybe we can do it that quick. Sometimes we can, sometimes we can't. Speaking of that, our shop is taking walk-ins now, something new that we didn't used to do. So mm-hmm. if you got a trailer-related problem and you need it fixed right now or you're getting ready to go through inspection, you found out something doesn't work, you could stop right on into Weller's and we will do it while you wait, hopefully, right? We got yep. two guys in the shop now. They both know what they're doing. We're doing a good job. We like stuff by appointment, so we honor appointments first and foremost. If you have an appointment, it's going to be honored. But if you need to stop in spur of the moment, we possibly can help you out with that.
We'll do our best to get you accommodated.
We have a lot of parts in stock now, and we're getting
even more
inventory weekly, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
So we're rearranging our showroom a little bit, and we are increasing our inventory on a weekly basis. So anyway, can I do a quick ad for L1W?
Sounds like a plan.
My insurance company, I love them. I was just talking to somebody the other day who buys their insurance from a company that's not from around here, and they've had a problem. And then when they called the insurance agent, they got referred to an 800 number, and that just set them off. I want to tell you what L&W's big claim to fame is. They sell insurance. They sell auto. They sell home, health, life, commercial. But the nice thing is when you need them, so you buy the insurance. But when you need them, when there's a problem, you don't need that 1-800 number. You need people that know you, that care about you, that know where your business is. And that's what L&W does. They've been doing this for over 84 years in our community. They get involved when you have a claim. That's when you really want your insurance agent, and that's when a lot of insurance agents bail. They're like, I just sold you the insurance. I got no dog in this fight. I'm out of it. Here's an 800 number, and you give it a call, and they aren't going to know what Sussex County. They're going to think it's Sussex County. So, in other words, you know, I'm just letting you know that a lot of people have had that bad experience, and they're like, that's why it was so cheap. So think about that, folks. When you need insurance and you want to deal with a local company that supports many local things, that supports our community, that's involved, it's like a mini army up there. When I call, I love it because they help me with things. I bought a new pickup recently, and I needed insurance, and the dealer kind of wanted the insurance dealt with right that minute. Man, they did it, and they emailed them and the card and everything. And it was like, wow, I didn't have to leave a message and hope somebody calls me. I mean, it was like spot on, just like that. So no big deal, but it was just kind of nice. But anyway, LNW Insurance Agency, 856-7828. I can't say enough good about them. 856-7828. Give them a call. Tell them I sent you. Talk to them about whatever you need or whatever you have and make sure you're adequately insured. A second opinion is always free. Anyway, one-stop shopping. So anyway, give them a call. 856-7828 on the World Wide Web. It's lwinsurance.com. Now, in a few minutes, we're going to take a break from the radio. So for those listening on the radio, I'm going to encourage you to switch over to either My Cozi TV or Facebook Live or WellerDoesDelmarva.com because Colin Walls and I are going to be talking about Yuletide Farms some more. He's going to be telling us some things, and I may just have a crazy, I'm in a good mood offer. Okay, so I want to mention that. Now, those listening on Delaware 105.9, I also want to invite you and even people watching on TV to tune in Monday morning and Tuesday morning on Delaware 105.9, because I will be guest hosting for the Vacationing Dan Gaffney from 5:30 to 9, and I'm going to encourage you to give me a call about anything you want to talk about within reason. So anyway, mark your calendar, mark your smartphone. Monday and Tuesday morning, I will be doing Dan's show as a guest host. But you are listening to and watching right now Weller Does Delmarva. We have a lot of things going on. The store is open. People's phones are ringing. Jason's had a customer already, got a holdy pole. That is something neat. And if you want to learn about our ads, go to Weller's. And so many people think you spell Weller's with an H. There's no H in there. They think Wheeler Dealer, and then add an H to it. Wheelers. It's not Wheelers. I am a Wheeler Dealer, but it's Weller's. Wellers. Weller's Utility Trailers. Wellers.com. 337-8228 is the number. Get in here and get some of these buttons. It says, it's okay to wish me a Merry Christmas. We're going to take a break from the radio. We're going to continue right on with TV, Facebook, and the streaming. And we'll be back with the last half hour of the show in just a few minutes. All right, I had to pause so that everybody could switch over. So now we're officially on the stream, on the Facebook, and we're on my Cozi TV. It's a cozy little place.
These half hours
are
flying by.
It is a cozy little place. The half an hours are flying by.
Wow.
Yuletide Farm's going to be open today at 10 o'clock. They're going to be lined up at the lane.
Yep.
First customer through the door is going to be the first one waited on.
That's right.
Okay?
That's right.
How's that?
I agree with that.
All right. Anyway. So
that's a great deal.
Going to be giving away free smiles today.
Yes.
And
no purchase necessary.
This is not a joke. You can actually take pictures there. You got a nice little setting inside the store. And there's a couple trees that my grandson climbed up in, and we took some good pictures. And I don't know if Colin encourages tree climbing or not. But
not necessarily, but
okay.
You know,
and
we might not discourage it. And the cat, there's a cat there, or maybe a couple cats roaming
there
around.
There could be cat napping.
Right. If you touch the cat, it is yours. You have to take it home. Right.
Yeah, because what it does is it immediately attacks you, and its claws are so deeply embedded, you can't shake it off. They made a song about this cat, Shake It Off. Anyway, the cats are very friendly.
They are
what
friendly.
What Colin is saying is there's a constant rotation of cats there, and if
yes.
you so desire to have that cat that's so friendly, he will allow you the opportunity to load it up in your car, or he will load it for you.
Right. And I want to stress that they are not our cats.
Okay.
They are just cats that are around there, and they hang around, and they seem to like us for some reason.
There you go. It's because you bring people in to pet them.
Maybe that's what it is.
I mean, who spends money to bring people to their place to pet cats?
I don't know.
Okay. All right. And you can get a picture of yourself and your tree and the cat.
Hey, we sell Christmas trees. We've got five varieties. We've got an event coming up this next Saturday, the 10th.
Yes, the movie.
We're going to have a movie there, the Polar Express. So go to YuletideFarm.com or Yuletide Farm on Facebook. Purchase your tickets right there.
Yes.
Get them ahead of time. And then you can also purchase them at right there at the
Unless
store.
Unless you're sold out.
Yeah. Well, if you're even if you're coming today, you can purchase them
at the store. Or online.
Right.
You can maybe get them the night of the movie, but your desire is that there is a big crowd and standing room.
There is a possibility that it sells out.
Right. Yeah. It won't be standing room only.
Right. You got to stand all the way in the back if you do that.
Correct.
Yeah.
All right. YuletideFarm.com, Yuletide Farm on Facebook. Go see them today. I went out there. I was there last year. We're doing the show there next Saturday.
Yeah.
Lord willing, and the creek don't rise.
Right.
So anyway,
this show we're doing there.
This
Saturday
show.
Morning.
What show? Oh, yeah. This show.
Yeah.
This show. That's right. Okay.
Do you want to talk about the Wednesday show real quick?
Yes, real quick.
Okay.
Live with Walls and Weller, we are gaining traction like a four-wheel drive vehicle with chains.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, last week was a great show, and our time is up for the
Yuletide
segment.
All right. Well, thanks for stopping by, everybody.
This is a new segment, so the clock starts again.
All right, here we go. Live with Walls and Weller.
Right.
Wednesday night, 7 to 9.
7 to 9 on Facebook Live.
Yes, we are over, I think, 1,100 or 1,200 views.
I think
so
we're
far.
Over 1,200 views on last
yes.
week.
So if you want to be on, you say, well, how much would it possibly cost to be on such a show?
Well, it depends on what you want to spend.
That's right.
Right, because what we do is we ask that when you come on that you possibly bring some kind of giveaway.
Yeah.
You know, if you're talking about a product or a business.
What did we give away the other night?
Oh, we gave away a rock salt lamp.
Yes.
We gave away a gift certificate. I was going to say a birth certificate. A gift certificate for a free yoga session.
Oh, yeah.
Core yoga.
Yeah, I don't remember. Kelsey.
Yes, and so got that. She's going to be on the show here, this show.
I just
show.
Remembered that. When is that?
A couple weeks, I think. 17th, maybe?
We're going to be doing live yoga on this show, folks. I may be
You'll want to
watching
see that.
Brooks do this.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're
anyway.
Use the hair-growing technique of yoga.
Yes. Anyway, I forgot what we were saying.
Our so show, what we were giving away, we gave away two tickets to John Brady's roast, the roast of John Brady.
Yes, yes. That's Wednesday night. This Wednesday night.
Yeah, December 7th, right?
Okay.
So there's lots of giveaways. There's lots of interesting people that we're talking
to. To be on, we want you to socially network right. this program for us.
That's right.
We also want you to bring some type of a giveaway.
Right.
And we aren't charging to be on the show.
Right. I mean, that's pretty simple. And I think for the exposure, you know, last week, 1,200 views. I mean, that's
correct.
That's 1,200 eyes.
And we take callers. Actually, so write down the number for that. It's 337-7300. Right. What else?
Yeah, well, the taking the callers is interesting because those are the people that are calling in and and winning the prizes.
That's what a caller is, folks.
And, you know, it's, if you're a business owner, that's a unique way to get somebody to come into your business
right.
is to give them something. And they
absolutely,
can, they
because
can,
then they got to pick it up there.
Exactly.
Let me think that one through. That's a great idea.
It is.
All right, call me if you want to be on the show right now. We're not charging anybody. But in the meantime, this is painless, less painless than having a tooth pulled. Like us at, I forgot the name already.
Live with Walls and Weller. Yes.
Okay. All right. Yep. Are we about done? Can I move
We've
on?
We've got a half hour left.
Half hour left?
25 minutes.
Okay. What did I miss, Brooks? Anything? I want to talk about our free calendars.
Sure.
Can I? We have some left?
Yes.
All right. So if you want a calendar, they're free. And we're not on the radio yet. No, we're not.
Okay.
Not yet. Would you relax over
there? I
didn't
think so.
Making me so nervous. Wow. I just want to see if I missed anything. He's so annoying sometimes, everybody.
Oh, I know. It's horrible.
Hey, well, one thing we could mention.
No. No. What?
You were talking about somebody when somebody was going to be on the show. If you go to WellerDoesDelmarva.com, there's a piece or there's a spot on the sidebar. There's a schedule. If you click on it, it pulls up a calendar, and you can actually see who we have coming on the show. As soon as I get the information, I'll put it on there. But then if you click on it. Like,
as soon as I feel like it, you'll be able to go there and find the stuff.
As soon as I get the info.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you, Brooks, for stopping
by. Go there, and there's nothing there right now but a blank calendar.
Right. Okay, I want to do a real quick giveaway. Are we getting ready to go back on the radio?
Yes, we are.
All right. I can't do it now. Tell me when we're on.
We are on.
Give me some kind of a signal that lets me know we're on the radio. Colin, you can help me here.
Okay.
I'm going to let Colin be my...
co-host?
Yeah, Vanna White.
Am I getting muted?
Oh, you were going to help me. I need somebody to put all the stuff up here.
Colin can, I'll let him handle that one.
And what, you'll describe it?
No, I'll just watch.
Okay. All right, we need you to grab some items and put them up here if you would, please. Is that your new phone?
That is my new phone, yes.
Oh, he's got a new phone.
Yes. Is
Christmas tree should sales
I,
must be
Should I pay you for it on the air?
No, I would not.
Not I heard fully, there was a really nice guy that delivered it.
Cell phones. What?
I said I heard there was a really nice guy that delivered it.
That's right.
Right. The UPS guy.
Here we go. This is a welding helmet. You're going to have to tell us about it, Brooks, because I don't know anything about it.
It's a welding helmet.
Okay.
You put it on your head.
Okay.
And then when you go to weld, the screen there will darken. So
what kind of screen? Like a movie
like
screen?
Where you look through.
When you wear this normally, there's like a movie going on.
It's like virtual reality.
Oh, this is a virtual reality helmet?
I'm at a loss for words.
So, tell us something that's not new.
This is like beat-up session on Brooks.
How about this, Brooks?
We're edifying you.
It's an auto-darkening welding helmet.
Yes.
It's a welding helmet. It's not a gaming helmet.
I didn't say anything about gaming.
Okay.
As you can see, it's lightweight and durable and has a ratchet-style headgear.
I love a ratchet-style headgear.
Right.
Because the opposite of that would be nails and screws. So this is... Anyway, these things are only like 50, 60 bucks. What do we got? Half a dozen left?
That's
we want to just get rid of them. So this is a go-away price, 20 bucks.
20
okay,
bucks?
Okay, 20 bucks. I'll tell you what else they're good for is if there's like a solar eclipse of the sun.
You can look at it?
You can look at it. Yes, no lie. I've done that before. But really? Not a solar eclipse of the moon, but the sun. All right, can we move on to the next item?
Please.
$20, folks, for Weldon helmets.
Auto darkening.
Very, very few trailer stores sell them, okay? We pride ourselves on this because some people make fun of us. All right, what is this? This
triple
is
tap.
A triple tap.
Triple tap.
All right, so this is a cord that has a 30-amp plug on one end, and you stick it into a generator. Or, like, even if you're at home and you got a 30-amp plug, or you go camping and they have a 30-amp plug, you just plug this in. Because what's it do on the other end? It gives you three more plugs. So how much is this, Brooks? This is a 25-foot triple-tap cord, 30-amp. What are we looking at, $100?
Normally, they'd sell for right around, actually, $75, but they're on sale for $45 right now.
$45?
Yeah.
Get out of town.
That's all better right. than you can find them online.
Yeah, and who buys online to support local businesses?
No,
okay.
This is 10-gauge wire
that's
on that, too.
What's the next wire. Item? Let's talk about these license plates. $2 each, right?
Yep.
Okay, six for $10. Come on, Brooks, can you keep up with me here?
I'm trying to.
Folks, the
yes,
speed of the
yes.
team is the speed of the leader.
Yes, it's six for $10 or three for five.
All right, here we go. Thank you very
nine
much.
Nine for 15.
Next item. We're going to just toss all these on the floor.
Yeah, toss
out. All right. This one here is a hose reel. Not a water hose, but an air hose. It's got 25 foot of air hose. And I could tell you don't have a packet of ads over there. I can tell
I
it.
Have,
how,
I have them on the computer.
Going. Okay.
There's
anyway,
just so many ads trying to keep up which item.
Okay. That's what I'm saying. I can't. I need you too. Get a camera on Brooks sometime.
Oh, there right? is a camera
people
on Brooks.
See this. We have to work with this.
See my
day.
Face turning red because I'm stressing out.
Okay, well, I am too. This is a live show, man. Got to keep it lively. Anyway, what's the deal here? Is this a water hose, air hose?
It's a retractable air hose reel.
So it bolts to the wall or the floor or whatever, and it's got air hose on it.
It comes with 25 feet of air hose.
Does it include the air compressor?
It does not include the air compressor.
But we probably could sell them one.
Absolutely.
All right, so how much is this? $80, $70.
Right now? $35.
Now, I know that one's below cost.
Mm. I'm sure it is.
I'm sure it is. So what we're saying is $35 for a hose reel. Is this new or used?
They are brand new in the box.
Are they really?
Absolutely.
All right, I'm not going to throw that one.
That
okay?
One, that one might make some noise.
Right. I did mention the extension cords, didn't I? Have we got the paintbrush stuff? Now, what is this? Ink pens. I can't even imagine how I got these. I have been peddling these things for a while now. I think it was when I owned stock in Papermate, but I'm not sure. And this is a Papermate ink pen, 10 of them. 10 of them. Aren't they on special? Come on, Brooks, help me out here, please.
I'm looking for them.
I know. Anyway, 50 ink pens for $1, folks. 50 ink pens for $1. Here's a helpful hint, Brooks. When you see him put something up here, that's what you start looking for.
I started looking for them.
50 ink pens for $1. 50 ink pens for $1. Mm-hmm. Think about that.
That's a deal. That's a bargain.
Deal. How much is that a piece? 2 cents a piece?
That's too much math.
Okay.
Yes.
Can you see the next item?
Yes.
This is my favorite.
Okay. I've already got your price on
TV. I'm getting frustrated because I got 150 items to go over with you here, and we're taking more than a minute an item. What?
I like this. I like
well,
the, it's a
like
spool of string. But I like how you measure it and how you tell people how much string
Why,
is there.
Say?
It's the height of it.
Oh.
So this is an 11-inch string spool.
Oh, my gosh. I didn't know how else to do it because I didn't have time to
measure it.
Oh, there's numbers in here. I can't read it, but there's right. a barcode and everything in there. Anyway, this is a spool of string. Now, when you come by here and you see how straight our trailers are lined up, we use this string for that. What?
But you're going to see that it's 11-inch string, but I guarantee there's more than 11 inches on here. They've measured the height of it.
Okay, I got it now. All right, okay, I see it.
And you've got a 6-inch string
okay.
also somewhere.
All right, so that's my marketing manager. Did you do that, Brooks?
I did not do that. I'm not going to take credit for that.
I don't
one.
Mean to give you such a hard time.
I'm good.
But I really do mean to give you such a hard time.
I understand.
Oh.
$2.
Like a kid on Christmas morning.
$2 on the string.
$2. Do I have a bid? All right, go
ahead.
Is
this the only place these are available?
Absolutely.
Another Weller's only item.
Absolutely. I had a lady come in, and she made hundreds of these, her and her husband, and they made them themselves. I don't know if they're hand-sewn or they sewed them with their own sewing machine, and I bought them all. hundreds of these things. And it's an umbrella carrier, like a beach umbrella. You put this over your shoulder, and the umbrella goes in it. And we're selling these, I think.
$4.75.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm.
Now, even you would agree that's cheap.
That's cheap.
This would be a great gift for your wife.
Sure.
Okay. Next item, Colin. I'll toss that one on the floor. Bubba Gump T-shirts. Personally endorsed by Brooks Ritter. These are very, very nice for the people that can see them. Bubba Gump T-shirts. What's it say
the
on the back?
The back is great.
Stupid is as stupid does. Did we make those shirts ourselves?
I wish we could take credit.
It reminds me of a local business that's nationwide. anyway, price tag right on them. You don't even have to tell me how much these are. $19. Got the tag right on them. They're brand spanking new Bubba Gump T-shirts. $19 a piece.
No, they're not.
Why?
They are $2 a piece. $2 a piece.
$2?
Yep. Or if you wanted to buy multiples.
That's a cheap rag.
Sure. Seven of them for $10.
How much is that? $4 a piece?
Well, no, that's less than $2 a piece.
Times four is 10.
That's less than $1.50 a piece.
There they are. That's the new math. The floor is piling up. Now, these. Oh, there was a paper earlier. Man.
Oh, I saw it. Right here.
Right here. These are the best of the best, folks. What's it say?
This is overshoes, men's and women's boot / combat.
So if you're getting ready to have an argument or go into combat, maybe you work somewhere in the complaint department. This would be the boot to wear. What are these things?
But these are lacrosse. They're lacrosse brand.
Get out of
Lacrosse
town.
Footwear Inc. Now, what I want to know is...
I missed that. And they're fairly fresh.
Right.
They were made in March of 1992. They're almost a collector's item.
But they've been packed in baby powder, it looks like, to keep them fresh smelling.
From 92 to now, how many years is that?
Oh, wow. Is that 24 years?
24, 25 years. Coming up on 25
These
years.
Are, after 20 years, they're a collector's item.
We need to raise the price.
We need to raise the price. What are these 24-year-old boots? They can't be. This form has just got to be. I didn't even know lacrosse was in business 24 years ago. This is hilarious. I'm glad that they can't see the boots. But anyway, how much are these things?
$6 a pair.
What if they just wanted one right foot?
They can say $6 and take the right foot if they'd like. Or you get
$6
two pairs.
$6 a pair.
Yeah, or you get two pairs for $10.
Really?
Yeah.
And they are, what is the word after something's 20 years old? Is it antique?
Antique, I think.
These are antique. Oh my gosh, I missed something to put in the ad. Antique combat boots.
Overshoes, overshoes.
Well, I wear them. I use them when it's snowing out and stuff like that. What?
Did you know that they may be worn in the event of chemical protection is required?
They may be. Well, they may be worn in the event an alligator attacks you.
It does say check for holes or punctures if you're going to use them for chemical protection.
Okay. I'm going to toss that one over there. All right. Hey, folks, in case you didn't know it, the deals are sweller at Weller's, and if you want to know where all your Army surplus goods end up, right here at Weller's.
If somebody thinks the deals stink.
And if you wonder if the government buys more than what they need, no, they just keep it too long, 24 years. All right, what's next? Air fresheners. All right, these are one size fits all.
Five.
Now, Brooks, you tell me. I had somebody say, what do? Rub it under your arm? I don't know. How do you use this air freshener?
I just sit them somewhere and open them up so they smell
good.
Stand
near them?
If you want to get the scent. Nice.
Oh, it's more for a room.
Yes, it's not for you. It's not made for you to smell better.
Oh, I thought this was a personal air freshener.
No, that would be deodorant.
Okay, I had it mixed up. All right, I just saw the little slits in it, and I was thinking that you rub it or something like that. But you're saying that you put this in a room.
Yes.
Or your car.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and these things here are probably $1 a piece or two for a dollar or something like that.
How about five for a dollar?
You got to admit, you got this stuff priced pretty cheap.
Yeah.
If I was in the buying mood, I'd buy all this stuff and resell it. And I probably was in that mood at one time.
That
now
makes
I'm
sense.
In the opposite mood. I just want to get rid of it.
You probably paid more for that.
Hey, we need some callers. We need to know if anybody is enjoying this segment of the show. Okay? How are we going to do that?
I'd
I don't
say
know.
If you give away five of those air fresheners, you'd get a caller.
All right. Here's what I'm going to do. For every person that calls and says something that gets through, we're going to give you a pair of them boots free. How about that?
Really?
A right and a left foot.
Wow.
Absolutely free. You call 337-7300. We want to hear from somebody, don't we?
Sure.
No, we don't. We do. We don't. I'm not sure.
You have to use the microphone up here.
Okay. Well, let me think about it because nobody's called yet anyway. Okay? I did give the number, didn't I?
No.
No.
Oh, okay. 337-7300 if you want a pair of these boots absolutely free. And then maybe we'll let you call next week and tell us what you did with them. Okay? Anyway, no callers. I'm going to move on to my next advertiser. Is that okay?
Sounds like a plan.
Don't go nowhere, though. We're going to talk about that. One there is one that has got to go. All right? All right. First Class Heating and Air. I want to talk about them. Great company. I deal with them for all my heating and air needs, and I deal with them on other things, too. They even do plumbing plus some home performance stuff, and they're just a great company to deal with. We're getting a phone call.
Searching.
Wow. Should we take the call?
That's your call.
I think
here
you're
we
calling,
go. You got
yeah.
the mic on?
Yes.
All right. We're going to end up giving something away. Maybe it's a wrong number. Hello?
I did not know you guys were on Cozi TV. You guys are great. This is a great show. I'm enjoying it.
I left a flyer in your mailbox.
You did you?
Yes. You must not have got it.
Maybe not, Jim. I don't know.
Are you watching us?
Yes, I'm watching you now.
Okay. And how is it?
It's great. It's fun.
Okay.
Got a lot of good product.
Some very good. What do you think of them boots we have?
I like them.
Do you want a pair?
Yeah, I do, Mr. Weller, if you don't mind.
Okay. What's this say? Oh, they were inspected. I found an inspection and a test date. Inspection and test date. When is this? 1997?
1997, so fairly recent.
They're currently inspected, okay?
It's only
no, that's fine.
Okay, so I guess we need your name.
Okay.
And Social Security number. Just your name.
Well, my name is Jack.
Jack.
And the last name is Coxe, is an echo, Jack Cox.
Okay.
And I live in Millsboro. I talk to you guys and Dan once in a while.
Okay. Well, good. So you'll come over and pick them up either today or next week?
Sure.
Okay, a pair of those boots, okay?
Over your store, in which store?
Bridgeville.
Jim?
Bridgeville.
Bridgeville?
Bridgeville, Delaware. Okay.
Yeah, no problem.
Any other comments?
I will. No, except I'm enjoying the show. You got a lot of interesting products that I didn't even know that you had.
Yep.
So I'll have to come over and have you meet Riley and see if you would, look around your store.
Okay. I met you at the parade, didn't I?
Yeah, I think you did, Jim. I think you did.
Yeah. Well, good. All right. Well, anyway, I'm enjoyed talking to you. I'm going to let you go, and you come get your boots, okay?
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you. All right, we gave away a pair of boots. Wasn't that nice?
That was great.
And he didn't know we sold all that stuff. And to be quite frank with the audience, I didn't know I still had all this stuff. Okay, again, be aware. I buy things sometimes by the tractor trailer load to where I get a phone call. And somebody says, I have a tractor trailer load of stuff. It's $100,000 worth of merchandise. And some of it's new, some of it's not, and we'll take $7,000 for the whole load. Do you want it or not? And I either got to say yes or no. That's how it goes. And I might get 10 of them phone calls a day sometimes. So sometimes I buy this stuff, sometimes I don't. So some of it's brand spanking new, the paper made ink pens, the air fresheners, the boots, they're all brand new stuff. It's just some company somewhere just said, we're done with it, get rid of it, and sell it to Jim Weller in Bridgeville, Delaware. So that's how it all came about, and we do it to have fun. I have had some other businesses kind of mock me or, make fun of it or whatever, a trailer store selling this and that. But, folks, we're just regular people here. We own a trailer store. Yes, we like to sell trailers and sheds and carports and swing sets and kayaks and so on. But we got to survive and we got to live. And so we sell many different things because our motive is to get you in the store and to meet Brooks and meet Brandon and Earl and Jason and Terry and say, you know what? Jim's got a nice group of people there, and when I need something, I'm going to go deal with them. And that's my overall motive, is to expose you all to us. So that way, when you need any of what we got or you know somebody that does, you will think fondly of us because we've been in business 42 years and we try hard to do a good job.
Finish it.
What was that?
You didn't finish the first class.
You're right, I didn't finish it. You're right, I'm sorry. So I'm going to start all over with my first class heating and air ad because it is a local company. Speaking of been around a long time, they've been in business 40 years. So I love these local companies that have been in business a long time. So anyway, first class heating and air. Yes, they will service your heater. They will install a new one. I'm getting some extra ductwork installed to another room. There's just all kinds of things they do. They offer maintenance agreements. They do home performance tests. They also do plumbing. So a little bit of everything. So if you want some remodeling and you're going to put in a new bathroom, they can help you with that. If you're adding on a room or your heating and air conditioning system's a little old, you want to see if there's any incentives out there or special financing, you know, that's where we're at right here at the store in Bridgeville. I don't want to buy it, but it's 16 years old, and I know the clock is ticking. It's served me well. I need a new system, so I'm just waiting for the right time. So it's first class heating and air, whether they sold you your merchandise or whether you bought it somewhere else and you just want great service. Their trucks are lettered. Their employees are wearing uniforms. They're drug tested, background tested. They're licensed. If they go in a town and work, they're licensed in that town. They don't just slide in and slide out. So reputable first class company, first class heating and air, 934-8900, on the web. It's the word firstclasshvac.com. They'll take good care of you, 24/7 emergency service, and they even have some very creative financing plans if you need financing. All right, can we move on to our product segment? Let's talk about this hat. This hat says what on it?
It says, don't tread on me.
Okay, and as you can see, it is a one-size-fits-all. How's it look, everybody?
It looks great. It almost matches
your skin
complexion.
So this hat, it does fit.
Yeah, right. I'm blushing. Anyway, I'm going to take a picture, and this is a one-size-fits-all because it's very adjustable. Is that right?
That's correct.
And what was I going to do? I was going to take a picture. So for those watching on TV, you can see it now, okay? How much are they, Brooks? Because I think they're $20.
They are $10.
$10?
Mm-hmm.
How much are two of them?
$20.
We don't even have two, do we?
Well, we did.
We can't get any more.
Yeah, we'll have to see how many we got left. For sure have one left because it's on your head.
Which is now used.
Still a great deal at $10.
Still a great deal at $10. All right, so anyway, how much are they?
$10.
No kidding. That's a good deal. They're real nice ones, though. They got that little Velcro thing on the back, and small brain, big brain, doesn't matter. One size fits all.
You know what I like about them? The brim is pre-bent to that shape, too. It's not that flat brim where you got to shape it. It's already bent.
I love it. It's a cool hat. I think I'm going to start wearing a hat. How's this look?
Kind of look like Brandon.
Styling?
You look like Brandon.
Really?
He used to wear his hat like that. I had to straighten it.
Really? I like it. Now, what if I wear it like this? How's it look? Oh, it just barely.
Now's when you should ask for callers for the fashion tips.
Yeah, we need some fashion tips. All right. So, anything else about the hat?
No, I think you've.
You might want to move on.
I'm out of myself. I need to quit wearing it. What's the next thing? Is there anything else? What?
I did see this deal. That is an exceptional deal right there.
This trailer?
Yeah. I don't know if you want to talk about trailers or not, but
not really, but I will. Okay, it's a landscape trailer. What is this thing? 12 foot long. That's wider than normal. And people say, what difference does that make? It's wider than normal because it has a gate on the side and a gate on the rear. And the reason it needs to be wider than normal is when you load a big four-wheeler from the side, if the trailer's not wider and the four-wheeler has racks, the gate won't shut. And we learned that the hard way because we had a whole bunch of trailers in stock that weren't wide enough that we sold. And then we realized when you're going to load a four-wheeler sideways, mainly the bigger ones with the racks on them, you need to make sure the trailer's 102 inches wide, which gives you about 82 inches between the floor. And it makes a big difference compared to 6 foot.
And I think a 6x12 trailer, if you try to load them front, pull them both on from the back,
right,
they don't fit. You would think they would fit. I'm just putting two four-wheelers on it. Yep. They don't.
They don't fit. So you need to load one sideways and one the other way. This has a gate on the side and a gate on the rear. And this trailer here was normally like $2,100. I bought a truckload. I got a really good deal. And then between now and the end of the year, and I do need to say this. I just made a bunch of radio ads saying this. Right now, it's not about making a profit. It's about we have got to turn as much inventory loose between now and the end of the year is humanly possible, but it's $1,499. So a normal 12-foot landscaper's like $12.99 to $14.99. This is $14.99, and it's wider than normal. Has a rear gate and a side gate, $14.99. And, of course, financing is available. I don't know what a payment would be, but it would be cheap. So we're about out of time. Thank you, Fran, and I'll see you Monday morning. But anyway, thank you to my Delaware 105.9 crowd. I've enjoyed being with you. Switch over to Facebook Live or My Cozi TV. I got a minute or two left there. Have a good weekend. God bless you all. All right, everybody, Jim Weller here. Going to do a real quick TV giveaway, okay?
Ooh, okay.
I need an item to give away.
Oh, these what right here. You were getting ready to give those away earlier.
That's right, I was.
Yep.
These buttons that say, it's okay to wish me Merry Christmas. You can have one absolutely free. Got to do one thing and one thing only. Dial 337-7300. Leave your name and number, and then you can pick one up, no problem. It's a nice little button, no big deal, but I want to give you one for free. Just call me now and leave your name and number, 337-7300, and leave it on the voicemail, and you can stop in and pick one up today or next week. But you got to call, otherwise you're not eligible. 337-7300. Thank you for watching the show. There are advertising opportunities in some way, shape, or form. If you want a commercial or something like that, we could talk to you about that. If you want to be on our Wednesday night show, Live with Walls and Weller, we got some openings there, and that's free. The TV ads would be cost money, but the
We're going to charge for those.
Free. Other than that, we've had a good time. How much time I got left? I don't even know.
You're ready to find out about 15 seconds.
15 seconds.
Yep.
And here is a customer pulling right up. All right, that's one phone call. Again, if you want the free button, 337-7300. Thank you. I've enjoyed being with you. I'll take any comments you have, and have a good weekend. God bless you all. Take care. Bye-bye.